Wag wag, Leeds. You're listening to the funniest podcast in the game from the heart of Liverpool with Adam, Dan, Sensei Carl, and Finn. This is the one and only Have a Word.
Brought to you by Manscaped, the very best products on the market for below the waist grooming.
Go, Ed, get on me.
Wish I was going to see the Lighthouse family, me. Tell you what.
Well, they're on in Chester Cathedral next Friday.
Hottest.
Is it Chester Cathedral?
That's what I just said.
Hottest ticket in town.
Oh, my God.
You've got such selective hearing, you know.
Well, I've got poor hearing right now. What? When is it?
Friday the
26th. Friday the 26th. I'm in the south of France.
Oh, yeah.
Again.
I'm down at Elton John's house. He's invited me over. I don't know why.
Probably wants to watch you bum someone.
Oh, yeah. I should have thought of
buy
that.
Buy tickets. Is tickets still on sale?
Yeah.
Now.
Let's go and do a double header. We'll do Lighthouse Family on the Friday, Darius Rucker on the Saturday. I've already got me Darius Rucker tickets. Hootie from Hootie and the Blowfish.
Hottest ticket in town. Where's he playing?
You know what's really funny? Wigan you say Cathedral. Hottest ticket, because and you'll love this, by the way.
Hootie's ticket.
Do you know the title of his tour is Starting Fires?
That's what I call my tour as well.
Starting Fires.
Get a VIP ticket for like
you'd recognise some Hootie
flares.
Songs? Some Hootie and the Blowfish songs?
Oh,
I only want to be with you.
No, not if you sing it like that. I'll probably miss what you're saying.
That's Vic Reeves, isn't it? By the way, VIP ticket to the Lighthouse Family. £90, that's it.
VIP?
Yeah.
Is that in the clusters? Cloisters?
It says first six rows. Yeah, first six rows.
The first six rows,
and you get to
VIP. Wow.
You get to kiss one of them.
Is this what cathedrals are doing now? Because no fucker goes. Just putting on the Lighthouse Family.
Yeah,
I mean, no fucker goes. Religion's as hot as ever.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, the church is flying.
Hot ticket.
That's it. Google, Apple, the church, they're all.
I bet you the church makes more.
100%.
Dan, don't
what,
you
the
do
Church of
church?
England? I bet it fucking doesn't.
The Church of England doesn't have cathedrals.
What?
It's only Catholic ones.
No! What are you on about?
What are you on about?
What are you on about?
There's one over there.
Me! Old King Henry VIII, Big Harry, he saw to that shit.
Big Harry.
Big Harry?
Who's Big Harry?
Big Henry VIII.
Why is he called Harry?
He just got called.
Yeah.
Did he?
Yeah.
Why? Is it just someone get it wrong and he didn't correct them?
No, it was the
like Chandler and Friends.
It was boys with his boys. He was Harry.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Is Harry like Shaw for Henry originally or something?
Possibly.
Because Jack Shaw for John, innit?
I think so. Yeah.
Carl is Shaw for Charles.
Because there was murder when our Jack was called Jack, because in our family. Because I was named after my granddad Vinny, and then after a week, everyone was like, that's too old-fashioned. They changed my name to Adam, which, you know, I'm sure everyone already knows. But then my little brother was called...
Hi.
My little brother was called Jack, but my other granddad's called John. And my mum's side of the family was like, oh, naming that one after the other granddad, but you changed Adam's fucking name, did you?
Oh, my God.
I'm sure I was just about to say that.
Because people back in the olden days were stupid, Carl, and they couldn't count.
Carl Shaw for Charlie.
William Bill, Richard Dick. What are the other ones? Can't
Hetty,
think of any.
Hetty, Henrietta.
Yeah.
I think.
Liz.
Lizard.
For Lizard.
Lizard, yeah.
The Queen Lizard.
Queen Lizard. The
Matty Banger for Matthew.
Hello.
No, the cathedral in Chester will almost definitely be C of E.
Why?
I think because you've got a Catholic cathedral, you're like, everywhere, yeah, there's not two Catholic cathedrals though, is there?
No, one of them.
Oh, no, Adam, no, don't fucking get me on the sectarian hook. We had the proper one, the good old C of E, the fucking non-papist, and then they were like, oh, all these fucking Catholics over here in Liverpool, give them a fucking new one that looks like a spaceship.
No, the Catholic's older than the Church of England, isn't it?
Paddy's Wigwam.
Is that the C of E? No, hang on. The new looking one's the Catholic one, isn't it?
In Liverpool, yeah.
Yeah, the old Georgian one is the C of E.
It's the Anglican, yeah.
Yeah, we're saying the same things.
Are we?
Yeah.
Okay.
We don't give a fuck about religion. You're a big religion goth.
I'm not a big religion goth. I just know my... I just
know everything there is to know about religion.
No!
I'm not a big religion goth. Well, I just know everything. I can recite it word for word, but I don't know it.
That's the Reformation, wasn't it? Big Henry.
We don't even know what that word is.
No,
that was when Henry went, whoa, I want to shag bear pussy. Man, going to make my own church.
He had Thomas Cromwell in his ear going, hey, do you know this church? They run a lot of fucking shit. Should we take all their money off them? Plus, you get to shag this crazy bitch, Anne Boleyn. And he was like, do you know what? You're right, Tom. About 11 years later, he chopped his head off.
She invented blowjobs, so I kind of get it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She was the suck woman.
And she had an extra little digit on her hand. She had a little finger. So it, oh my God, yeah, he had six fingers in. Big Harry was a dirty boy.
Six-fingered Andy.
So he got all the money for the church. Fucking all the monasteries got disbanded. And I think the most of the cathedrals, old ones, are C of E, I think.
Anne was good at bowling. She could do two balls at once.
Anne bowling.
Six fingers. Nice.
She invented 10-pin bowling.
Well, she had six fingers. She could do two balls in one hand.
and no one went, that's not fair. They went, do you know what? She got enough fingers. Let her throw four of them. Even though the rest of us only throw one despite having two hands.
So they called it
she
Anne bowling.
Throw four.
She was a phenomenal swimmer.
Was
yeah.
She?
Yeah, yeah. Them extra fucking digits.
You didn't know what he meant by swimming, did you?
She invented swimming.
Oh, did she?
Up until then, they all just drowned. Which?
You know, like they say, she invented blowjobs. You know the way, like, there's loads of people who were credited with inventing certain things. Like
Michael Jackson didn't invent the moonwalk.
Yeah. I think there's...
No. What?
There was a guy on telly, I can't remember his name. What's his name, Harry?
That is true.
Bill Moonwalk.
Oscar Wilde invented the moonwalk.
Original, it was Chris and William.
But he was the first to do it, and I was obviously huge. I was like, yeah, Michael Jackson. Someone else did it before him.
Yeah.
No.
Yes, what was his name?
And see, this is what happens, is you've been fucking misinformed for years by the mainstream media, right?
Yeah.
Bill Bailey.
Bill Bailey.
Bill Bailey did the moonwalk. Yeah.
On Buzzcocks. No, he wasn't the first, but there you go. You've been fucking done there by big
people. People get credited with inventing stuff, but like, there's no way she's the first woman to have a cock in her mouth in like the 1600s or whatever it was.
Cave women were sucking birds. 1600s.
I couldn't let that one go. No, at some point, Ugbug and, you know, Snug Snug in a cave, Ugbug went, Snug Snug. And Snug Snug was a dirty old bitch. She was
There's no way she's the first gobbler. 1,500 years after we started counting.
I'm reading
joking.
Some stuff. They weren't happy about the blowjob. It wasn't a welcome. It wasn't a welcome change to England. It was
the
seen
only
as
people who weren't happy about blowjobs were people who weren't getting blowjobs.
It was blowjobs. Seen as wasting.
Women love sucking cock and men love getting the cock sucked. What's the problem?
It was seen as wasting any potential male heirs.
Oh yeah, because they were fucking for people back then, weren't they? They wanted the fellas.
Oh, yeah, and there was no man just having a little spaff when his missus was out doing the shopping. Load of shite.
Let me suck you off again, John. What, with four daughters? Never. Yeah.
Yeah. And but now, she didn't invent that. No chance.
No, I think she just... She's like Michael Jackson. She's the first one that did it.
On the big stage.
Yeah.
In court.
She brought it to the mainstream.
Yeah, she sucked Henry VIII off.
Fact?
Yeah, so like she was just on the big stage, wasn't she?
Fact's what she's known for.
Michael Jackson didn't do that.
Check her Wikipedia page. Blowjob Boleyn. And she had a little sister.
Did she?
Yeah.
Go on.
She was shagging Henry VIII as well.
Was she?
Who? Yeah, the other Boleyn girl. They should make a film about it or something.
Oh, yeah.
Have they made a film about it?
Yeah, have you? Yeah.
What's it called?
It's called The Other Boleyn Girl. It's a bit on the nose.
Is it really?
Yeah.
The other Boleyn girl, and what she was just chewing Henry as well.
She was fucking
that's
Henry before,
film.
Yeah.
She was with Henry first. So yeah. Anne stole Henry off his sister.
They were all pawns, all their dads. I can't remember the fucking Boleyn dad. Ow. But John, they wanted power, so they were like, hey, you know, Catherine of Aragon, she sucks no dicks. Tom. These daughters.
Thomas Boleyn.
Yeah, they positioned there to be like, that's what they use the daughters for.
So he sends his first daughter in, and she's shagging Henry VIII, and he's like, she's half shite. And then he's gone to his other daughter, hey, you go in, but don't just shag him, suck him off as well. And then she's credited with inventing blowjobs.
That was it. End of church. Divorce. He invented divorce.
Imagine that being that good at sucking dick, that he make a new church.
Yeah, that's how good she was. Phenomenal swimmer, incredible at 10-pin balls, and noshed everyone off. Then she got executed for cheating, essentially. She sucked someone else off. A musician.
Yeah. Michael Jackson.
Michael Jackson. And Bill Bailey.
A musician, really?
One of the court sort
of. He was probably a loop player, wasn't he?
Yeah,
he wasn't like a fucking rock star.
Doth take a ride. Yeah. Dost thou take a ride?
That might be what happened, though. She might have been so good at sucking him off that he invented a new church. Imagine being so good at eating pussy, you'd invent like a new type of yogurt or something.
At the same time.
When women are just like, I'm not doing this yoga anymore. Because I want him to meet me pussy. We need to do mesh Adam Rowe yoga.
Isn't it
Adam Roga?
Isn't it what Vikram did? Vikram, wasn't he a nasty man?
Oh, Bikram?
Wasn't he licking?
Yeah, he got done, didn't he?
Yeah, he was basically
turn the heating up. Get naked. Let's stretch.
Phoebe's following friends, wasn't he?
Vikram. That's a real name. A lot of friends. Yeah, but he was naughty, wasn't he?
Yeah, he's got Bikram's got proper me too, doesn't he?
Yeah.
When was he around though?
30 years ago, was he?
Yeah. Oh, really?
So he literally invented yoga ago? To get on the pussy.
He sounds old though, him. He sounds like 17th century or something.
Oh, he's Indian.
What?
He's Indian.
Oh, that's the same thing, isn't it?
It wasn't like Bikram Smith, was it? From Bayars. It's a name that we don't
Bikram
really have.
Smith. It's Bikram Smith. From Mars, no, from school.
It's Bikram Chowdhury.
You could have guessed that.
He could be from Bayars. There's loads of Chowdhurys. Paul?
I know no Chowdhury.
That's the only one you've got in it.
Yeah.
No? Anjum?
Anjum Chowdhury?
Oh, yeah.
Shout out. Who knew we were going to get there from the Reformation? Not a lot of people. Yeah, sweat. It's just, you just call it sweaty yoga, innit? They don't know, they call it hot yoga.
I do hot yoga, it's great.
Do you what? Still do it?
Well, I've been for
do you know
six
the
months.
Things you do?
I think
man.
You did it three times.
You did it three times.
Whoa.
No. This is in the same category as rock climbing, which I think you did once.
No, when I moved in, I did it constantly with Steve and then ruined
constantly?
It.
24/7. Yeah. Sorry, babe, I'm rock climbing again. Of course you're not.
The episode's not ready. He's up that rock.
No, we used to go to a yoga hub on Old Hall Street, and then we went to the one on Smith Down Road. But life kind of gets in the way with...
I think you get away with murder on this podcast and from our listeners. I think you start and don't finish shit and don't continue with this so much more than I do.
Give me one.
Yoga.
No, but I still do it. But
when was the last time you did yoga?
Oh, about 6 months ago.
Right, and but you still do it. So you haven't done it for 6 months, and you can sit there and look me in the face and tell me that you still do it.
When was the last time you played golf?
Oh, but it's winter. You can't throw that at him.
Why?
Because it's a seasonal
it's
sport.
It's the winter of yoga.
No, it isn't. Golf's a seasonal sport.
No, we haven't been. Life's just gotten away, but we need to go back. Yeah.
You didn't hear 75 hours a week?
Nah, less than that. Probably 30 minutes. But yeah, I like yoga. Hot yoga's great. I did it in uni, it helped a lot.
And when did you last do rock climbing?
I don't do rock climbing. Right. He said that.
You did though?
You did do rock climbing.
No, I did, yeah, but I don't. I'm not saying I'm still doing
it. Ice skating? Because you do... Wait,
no,
you know?
I planned on doing that. And just,
He's full of shit, and he gets away with it. Because he sits over there, everyone's like, oh, Carl's great.
How many books
we all
read?
Love Carl, don't we?
How many books
Carl
have you read?
Carl follows through on things. Shite.
The thing is, Adam, what you do is you go, I'm starting this thing and I'm going to do... You set these massive targets.
Name
so
one
everyone,
time I've done that.
Books.
What do you mean?
Books.
That was a lie.
Yeah, okay. Butty vans.
Yeah, that's in progress.
Go on.
What do you mean?
What have you got to with the butty van?
I text some people who own vans and say, can I buy that?
Have they text back or have you not checked if they've text back?
They might as well text back. Yeah. I do want a butty van.
He ate a butty last week, that's what he meant.
Basically, I want to make my own butties in a car.
At a golf course. He's just going to combine everything. I'm reading books, I'm making sandwiches, teeing off.
What about your journal?
Great place for a butty van.
How's your journal going? Yeah.
My journal's going quite well, actually.
Is it?
Yeah. Writing it every day.
What have you written yesterday?
None of your fucking business. Whoa, go on.
I'm happy to be contradicted. You don't seem like an everyday journal kind of guy. And it's a surprise.
That is the worst thing you've ever said to me.
Nah, it's not the worst thing I've ever said to you.
I write in my journal every single night.
Has it got a special lock and it's all secret?
Yeah, is it Dear Diary?
No. It's there. It's on my nightstand.
Dear John.
Pen on top of it, you know? Good pen as well.
Oh, yeah.
Write better stuff with a better pen.
Yeah. £3,000 pen. You've got to have that. Otherwise, you're not going to write in your journal. 800 quid on the journal. This is a good investment.
I write 2 pages every night.
What?
Try and fill 2 pages.
And this is just, is this to do with the therapy you're doing? It's like no?
No, it's just like self-affirmation.
Right. Is it just Adam?
It's just, so like on the left-hand side, what I try and do, is write about what's gone on. What? Try and write about what's gone on that day and how I've felt about it.
Is the right-hand side enemies? Gobshite.
The right-hand side is sort of how I've dealt with it and what I've done right and what I've done wrong and trying to sort of get more right than wrong.
Yeah. My journal is on Paddy's desk.
You can't have every day this year. Come on. No, no.
No, not every day this year. I reckon since since the start of February.
All right.
I've done every single day.
To be fair, he's been on form since the start of February. Had a shitty January. What have you got out?
Run out of battery. My journal's run out of battery.
The only time I don't do it is if I come in hammered and then I do it the first thing the next day.
I think that's the thing you should do the most, the hammered journal. What have you done today? Fucking loads. Fucking paint.
Yeah.
I started doing it. I wanted to do it every day, but sometimes I haven't got anything to say that day.
Just life gets in the way, doesn't it?
So what's mad is as well, I started my healthy regime again yesterday. And you're not going to believe this. So yesterday, I had two meals. I had my chicken and broccoli for my lunch. And I had scrambled eggs on toast for my dinner quite late. I had a busy day yesterday.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
11 o'clock at night. And I lost 2.5 kilograms in a day.
Did you have a massive shit as well?
Yeah, so I think what I did was, yesterday morning, I'd ate and drank.
No reading it, but there's my journal. No reading it, but there's my journal. So I did journal. You're not allowed to read it because it's like...
No, you don't. I'd ate and drank loads of Guinness late the night before, so I woke up and weighed myself before I had a shite to give myself the highest possible starting point.
Absolutely.
And this morning, I woke up, went for a massive poo, and then weighed myself.
Brilliant.
I'm also... This is mad because I'm 87.7 kilograms right now as of this morning. The lowest I got to a couple of months ago was 87. So I'm only 0.7 kilograms heavier than me lowest point. But I don't feel like I look like that. I feel a bit puffy.
Is that the journal?
I feel a bit puffy in the face.
You're 13, I feel a bit chunky. You're 13.7 stone.
Sure.
That's good. That's good. You're well down. Well down on what?
I was 102 kilograms.
I cannot do this kilogram malarkey that we're doing. Yeah, 102 kilograms.
I mean, it's probably easy. In fact, it is easier.
Damn. 16 stone. Decent.
Yeah, I lost 15 kilograms, which is essentially 33 pounds.
Yeah. So good.
But I'm trying to get in Nashville shape now.
You're still gymming it, Dan.
I have been, but again, it's been a busy week.
No saunas or anything?
I was drinking with Jamie. Yeah, I do. I love the sauna. Well, I don't think I can go in the swimming baths because of my manky, stupid skin. It gets fucking annoyed by the chlorine. So I do go in the sauna again.
Wear a wetsuit?
All the lunatics. A wetsuit.
That's what it's for getting in the water and it covers your
skin. It is for getting in the water, but not at Total Fitness Chester where you would look like a winter swimming paedophile.
Why but you get to swim? What do you care for?
I do. I really like swimming. And then the sauna's like the little treat at the end, isn't it? It's the pudding.
Anything happened in the sauna this week?
There was a guy shadow boxing.
Did you already know that, yeah?
I did.
What's
yeah.
going on?
I was trying to get there.
What's happening there?
He's offering you out.
It's mental. Out of nowhere, everything was shaved. You know Neo from The Matrix shaved?
Was he in there?
Wait, yeah, Neo, yeah, he was there. Like, where you're like, lad, did you shave your eyebrows? He just didn't have a fucking hair. And he was like, you know, like, just go in there and shut the fuck up. I don't even mind it. Cheers, mate. You know, as you like, if it's busy, but he was on the lowest rung and he was doing that thing where he's like really, like loads of movement, pouring water on himself.
He's peacocking?
And then just got up and went.
Yeah, it's Bikram shadow boxing, isn't it?
Buy a sauna, do it on your own.
No, it's not everyone can afford a sauna.
No, you can't go in.
Shadow boxing in saunas is not just for billionaires, Dan.
It's mental. It's so mental.
It's a power move. He's made you look a dickhead.
It's a what?
It's a power move.
Yeah. I don't feel like a dickhead. I feel like...
He's offering you a scrap and you just sat there and...
It's just another person with mental health issues.
Sit down, Mr. No Hair Man.
Mental behaviour. And if you're watching, going, lad, I always shadow box in saunas. Everyone thinks you're a psycho.
By the way, this is a screech, but it will not leave my mind at all until I say this out loud. You mentioned Neo from The Matrix. Do you know? This is an absolute fact, by the way. Wow. And you can Google this. Do you know? It was written by, or like it was presented as a, to the people funding the film, by a Cockney fella, and it was meant to be Neil, and it, they thought he was saying Neo, and that's why he's called Neo in the Matrix, because he was called Neo.
Doesn't Neo mean one?
Yeah.
I'm just telling you.
That can't be true. Yeah, you're the chosen one, yeah. Neil.
No, Neo means one.
I think they wrote that afterwards.
They wrote the crux of the story after they'd sold it.
I'm just telling
someone
you.
Someone sold you a bastard of a lie.
No, I watched it. I went on like a deep dive with it. It's true. It's true.
I hope it's true more than anything on this planet.
I promise you it's true.
Neil Trinity and Morpheus. Oh, yeah, Neil Trinity Warner and
Brothers,
Morpheus.
All of Warner Brothers are sat there in Burbank in fucking Hollywood, and the guy's like, all right, fucking belting script this. Fucking Matrix, innit? Mad cunt. He's in a fucking, he's in a computer world or something. It's called Neil. Oh my God, I love it. Neo.
Come Neo. On.
Blue pill, red pill, off his fucking bonnet, mate. He can read a fucking internet.
Ah. Who's told you that? Who's told you that?
Oh my God.
This is a fact, by the way. Screech
and
this.
You can Google this. Morpheus Trinity.
I will put my fucking life savings on this.
Yeah, did Google show anything, Finn?
No, Google showed one thing that said someone watched The Matrix and misheard it for the whole time. It was Neil.
I just made it up.
It's brilliant. So good. So good. It's perfect. Your bullshit is so good.
You said Neo, my brain went. Sounds a bit like a Cockney fella saying Neil. Like, make a story up, Adam.
All right, Neil.
Neil Morpheus Trinity.
I love it how you managed
Morpheus,
to
Morpheus, where's Neil? I don't know Trinity.
Trinity! Where's Morpheus and Neil gone? They've gone down the fucking wagon and rascal for a few boners.
Pattle of boners.
Gonna go see the fucking Oracle, mate. She's down the bookies. Yeah, put a tenner on each way, mate. Yeah, I think it's gonna come good. I need to rewatch that.
Which?
Matrix.
It needs refilming with Neil as the main character.
It's aged perfectly, hasn't it? It's one of the most aged films
Who's
ever.
Who's in it? Why am I blanking on Keanu Reeves.
Ah, mate. Lawrence Fishburne. And that woman who looks a bit like Monica from Friends.
Yeah.
And then the guy. Oh, Trinity in the PVC. That was a young twitch for Dan Nightingale.
Was he, yeah?
Yes, mate.
Goff. What are the Asians she called looks, that all look the same?
She looks like a BDSM Chinese? Irish lesbian. Mr. Anderson.
No.
What?
No. Agents.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. That's the Cockney guy with the scripts again. He's these fucking Asians. They all look the same. They're all called Chowdhury. Sorry, Anderson.
Honestly, I thought you said Asians. I'm
Agent Smith is what we're looking for.
Yeah.
He's coming. Oh, no, he was Mr. Anderson, wasn't he?
Yeah.
Agent Smith.
Mr. Anderson.
Sorry. He kept saying Mr. Anderson, who was your man from Lord of the Rings?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Australian guy.
Can't help it. I heard what I heard.
That's a cut. It's fine then, isn't it? No, but Trinity was amazing in the PVC. I mean, she probably doesn't look
that's
now.
What she's
but
doing
like,
now.
What? No, she was in the film in
no, she's selling
black PVC.
Stuff.
Oh,
she?
I thought you meant she was selling stuff on.
She's selling
yeah, that's QVC, isn't it? QVC.
Selling power mops on the telly.
Trinity's amazing now. The stuff I've bought of her. It's because she's fit.
You ever bought
this? Is a mop that's also an iron.
Ooh, it irons the floor.
Finn's trying to produce. Have you ever bought anything off QVC? I've never bought
They're
anything
They're fucking
PVC.
Insane.
The mop those... iron.
This is a mop. It's also an iron. And also, you can hit your husband with it when he's doing your head in.
Real catch. And
there's
only two left.
Oh, well,
we've restocked. There's 3,000 now, and we've just put the price down to a quid.
Oh. Wait, we've just looked around the corner in the warehouse. There is another 17,000. We are sorry. They've all gone again. They're back again.
Anyway, that's gone. Who wants some diamond earrings?
Do you know what's sick on that? And I never bought one because I was a kid. The shit, that like chopped veg in that. So then ones.
Chop.
You put like a tomato in it and come out like a fucking, I don't know, like in a million pieces.
Yeah. For all those recipes where you need a million pieces of tomato.
Yeah. I don't know.
I feel like that advert, you know, on the old Freeview channels before the actual programming started.
JML.
There'd be loads of the chop thing. And then also some sort of fitness thing for your abs. Yeah. It'd always be like, oh, the roller abs.
The insanity workout. Yeah. That was your bit, wasn't it?
Yeah, I heard a bit about it, but then there was a bit from an American comic who was massive that was just almost exactly the same years later, and I had to stop doing it. Dead annoying.
But the I think I've bought one at some point where you put it in and you just chop.
Yeah.
And then they break.
They're just an absolute fucking waste of time. You want like a good knife. And
love that. I love that on videos when they've got like a black glove and they're just fucking. You know, like the very quick recipe things.
Yeah.
Where they.
I used to use your knives. That was your gift to me when I moved in.
Are they all right?
They're great.
Great.
I've lost one. Don't know where. That's worrying.
You've lost the knife?
There's six knives and one.
Knives do just disappear from your house. And it is like concerning that I'm just going to get stabbed to death at some point. But
I've got a 3-year-old. Knives don't disappear. If like that, there would be a massive inquiry.
Oh. Hello.
Well, that went weird, didn't it? We had a little blip. We're back. It's fine. Laura's birthday tomorrow.
Yeah.
Laura's birthday tomorrow.
Going to give it a good loving?
I think there's a chance we might get some good loving. There's been mention of her now. Oh, basically. I think that's
if she doesn't want it, then you can't have her.
Carl, I do understand that.
Just because it's her birthday doesn't mean it's sex town.
Well, she was like, I'd like to maybe just take it easy and have a nap at some point. Like, yeah, you know what that means.
Sleeping in the day.
Sexual intercourse.
I mean, hopefully. I'm getting her a Fitbit. She's not asked for it, but she needs to get in shape.
Oh, no. That is a weird thing to give a woman.
Get an Apple Watch.
No, she's asked for a Fitbit Sense 2, one of the good Fitbits.
Is she on TikTok?
What?
I don't know, I feel like she's one of them.
She's an absolute talker.
Yeah, I feel like
she goes to the she's got a degree from the University of TikTok. Yeah, she comes up with all sorts of shit. So, Ladies' Day tomorrow. She has been dieting. She's done really well. She's lost stone and a half more.
Wow.
And that's a lot of weight for a woman.
Yeah?
Like it takes women ages to lose weight, doesn't it?
Yeah, they hold piss loads, don't they?
She's like a camel, a sexy camel. Yeah. She has been dieting since the new year. Yeah, it's taken a while, but she's done great. And I think she's going to blow it out tomorrow. She's been talking about maybe hickories.
Her back?
Just a diet. I'll try. I don't know if I've got a blow of the back out, me.
Were you ever like overly confident sexually? Like, would you ever have said something like that to a woman? You know, like back in your dating days, would you have been like, get back to ours, I'll blow your back out. Would you ever have said anything like that?
You're about to have the best night of your life. Dun, 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 dun. No, it's not really my style, Adam, to be like, hey, what come back here. Said? And I'm going to give you 7 to 8 minutes of the best 3.8 inches you've ever had. What?
What would you have said? Like if a girl's like, what are you going to do to me when you get me back? What would you have said?
I'd be like, I'll touch it.
What are you
going
to do to me?
That'll turn it off though, won't it?
It didn't turn it off. I mean, we're not cold calling. This is when it's all happening. Innit?
Yeah, hello. Hello, have you got 2 minutes to talk? What are you going to do to me if I come to yours?
This is in the taxi on the way back where it's all fucking booked in.
I'll touch it.
Oh, yeah. What are you going to do? I'm going to do a lot. Oh, yeah.
Tell me.
You think of it. I'll do it.
I can think of it, but I want you to tell me.
Sex.
You're going to fist me?
No.
Why?
Don't think of that.
Why?
I don't know. No one wants... fisting?
What's happening to my ears?
No one wants fisting.
No.
What are you talking about?
Because what are we going to do? Fist first and then I turn up with a chipolata? That's not good, is it?
You don't go that way round. That's putting you warm up.
Tom stayed in the middle and then you've got an open spot closing. We don't need that.
Yeah. You warm up.
You warm up.
How are you going to get me fist ready, love? Come on.
Fucking Anne Boleyn, you lad.
Yeah, what are you going to do to me ass to get me ready for me fist?
What? What? Have you ever spoken to any woman? Has Serica ever... What are you going to do to me arse to get it ready for the fist? Hey, taxi driver, ignore this.
I've never fisted the woman.
Cool, good. Put it on the list of all the shit you haven't done. Ice skating, fisting.
Not in 6 months anyway, so don't do it anymore. Do I?
Life gets in the way. As do sphincters.
Go on, Dan, talk sexy to Adam. Get him ready. God. Get him wet.
Yeah. Oh, I'll take you home. Kissy, kissy.
What are you you're pushing
away? Have you got her a present apart from the Fitbit? Have you got her any other?
Yeah, the foreplay's done.
Oh, that's it. I've got some headphones. This is all shit she's asked for. But
what headphones have you gone for? Headphones or
she's gone for some Sony headphones because she's going to go get back to the gym. We're going to go and shadow box together.
Nice.
But I need to get her a surprise today. At some point, I need to nip out and be like, "This is the thing that you didn't ask for."
Get an old El Pasto fajita kit. Nice. Won't be expecting that.
Nice. She will not be expecting that. Hey, eat that and then I'll fist you. You know what you like.
There's not an old El Pasto kit. It's just bread.
Yeah. Bread and a bit of dust.
That TikTok.
Stephen Buchanan said.
Yeah.
Get her some flowers. Such a tap in.
Absolutely. Yeah. Box of flowers now.
Yeah.
It's not a bunch, is it? Man's got to get a box. What?
Put your dick to the bottom of the box of flowers. So
yeah, because everyone reaches to the bottom of flowers, don't they, Carl?
When do you pick them up?
What are you on about? They get them out and start cutting them. That's not where I want
them. Yeah, when you literally go to where, by the way, my cock's at the bottom of this box, so reach in and wank me off.
Nice.
Happy birthday.
Which is what you do with Pringles, is it? Yeah. Hey, do you want a crisp? And to give me a hand job, because my dick's in the Pringles. Hey, footnote, there's no Pringles. I've eaten them. It's just my dick. Don't bite it.
No.
Just to be clear. Right, so I'm getting an old El Paso fajita kit, some Pringles, and I'll eat them and then stick my dick in them, and a box of flowers.
You said Pringles, you said boxes of flowers.
All right, yeah. Yeah, but definite box of flowers. I don't even think you can buy a bunch of flowers anymore. I think it's like, what, am I not worth a box?
It's
got to be the little box, hasn't it?
No, I think that's quite tacky, actually.
What?
I don't know, I think a box of flowers is quite tacky. It's like I was trying to buy me nan when she was still alive. I wouldn't get me nan a bunch of flowers. I'd get her a box of flowers.
And stick your dick in it?
No, get her a box.
No, like, I wouldn't.
It just looks more presentable.
No, I'd just get a nice...
What's tacky about... Why are you getting snobby about
Carl's
flowers?
Just being tight. That's all it is. Carl's just like...
Whoa, I've got art on Lark Lane. I travel all the way to Lark Lane for my flowers.
From the Spanish Quarter.
Yeah.
She's the best. Don't get a box. Go down to a local lamppost. Fucking pull them off there. That's what women want.
They do. Women do love stories. So if you did tell them where you'd got it from, they would be like,
oh. Oh, this was near some railings. I imagine it's a happy story. Now touch my dick and eat my Pringles. And shart your steps.
Yeah, that's mad, that.
Yeah.
What about a surprise party?
What?
Oh, we'll do it.
I'm off tomorrow.
Me too. Well, I'm not. Because I'm having
the birthday present she wanted.
Let's have a surprise party in yours. I'll get a DJ. I'll get a gazebo.
It's all the things she loves.
We'll all come. You can meet the kids for the first time in 14 years, and it's all boxed.
Jack can do photos. Will can film it. We'll do that bit. Laura's birthday Patreon special.
The Laura's birthday Patreon special.
We can look after the kids, and then you two can sneak off for a bit.
So good to have my wife's panic attack filmed in 4K. That would be so nice, wouldn't it?
Oh, what's the panic about? We all love her.
Yeah.
Happy birthday!
Imagine when she comes down
and
the stairs.
And that's what you do at parties. Is it, happy birthday! Get her sweating.
No, imagine when she comes down the stairs tomorrow morning and we're all already there and drunk.
Holy shit, you're there from when she gets up?
Yes!
Whoa!
That's the most surprising time.
Midday. Motherfuckers, be she'll ready be for 6 a.m.
She'll be expecting us come lunchtime.
No, she'll be expecting... Cool.
Midday, she gets
6 a.m. Party starts. Woo!
Happy birthday!
Guys, can I suggest, let's make this easier on everyone. I go out for breakfast, give her a Fitbit, stick my dick in some flowers. You know what ladies like. Fist her a little bit. I don't know. You know women. I don't. And then we go for a nap. And when she wakes up, she's like, oh, that was so relaxing.
We'll be in the wardrobe.
You'll be ready downstairs.
Like, bang!
Yeah.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Put your tits away, look. You're on a special.
Yeah, Will's
brilliant. God, that's
women love surprises.
What, Adam Rowe in a cupboard?
Have you ever done it to her?
The right woman would be into that.
No, yeah, but not necessarily my wife of 8 years.
No, women love, like, oh, you've thought of me there, thank you.
Yeah, what about a flash mob?
I think this was is a flash. Like a I think flash we're already mob? Organizing one.
Yeah, but we've not learned a dance yet.
Flash knob. You do
nice.
That.
He proper surprise party. You get your dick out. None of her friends are there because she'll be expecting that. Just people she doesn't really know that well. All getting drunk in her house at 6 o'clock in the morning.
Brilliant. Everyone's got a plus one. Everyone's got a plus five. Get the lads from school. Yeah.
I reckon we could actually do this on a day's notice. It'd be fire, by the way.
Would you?
Look at Will.
The kids
also,
in school?
Will called me a no man yesterday and I didn't like it.
What? What do you mean?
He was like, you always say no to everything.
Yeah, you are a bit of a no man.
Yeah. I am.
Matthew just say yes.
Yeah, Matthew said that.
It's true.
I just called you a bitch.
Yeah.
The kids are in school, is that correct?
The kids are in school. So this party can go off.
Till 3 o'clock?
Till about 3:10.
Yeah, because then they'll be home getting ready for the boxing, won't they?
they'll find some.
Dan, genuinely, would you be pissed off if we came to your house in the morning?
What time?
I don't know, half 10.
Yeah, that's mid-nap. Say midday, we'll wake up from the nap.
Yeah.
Yeah. And if you
can text us saying, I've just come, right?
Oh, and
nice. Then we'll be outside with a boombox.
Yeah, she'll have a post-coital
flush. I'll have to type it, not WhatsApp voice note, because I think she'll get suspicious.
Yeah.
Sorry, 2 seconds. I've come. So now you can.
No, it's like your journal.
Who's that to? Oh, well.
Your journal, innit? Your voice journal.
Yes, my voice journal. That's what I've been doing.
I'll cook. I'll do sliders.
That's nice.
That actually sounds good. That does sound good.
I'll tickle your back.
I'll bring some pretzels.
It's not my birthday.
Yeah, but I'll tickle your back then.
Oh, nice.
We could do this.
Yeah?
Come on, don't be a no man like you'd always are.
Well, yeah. I have to say yes.
Big no man.
Say, what have I been saying no to?
What? Everything.
Oh, you want to rent downstairs?
Can we have downstairs, Dan?
No.
There you go. Oh, no. Can we go to the Luke Combs Festival in Florida?
Who's saying no on that one, Carl?
I asked you.
I'll have to go with what Carl says.
Yes, we can have downstairs. Bosh.
I'll let you have downstairs if you all come to Luke Combs.
Deal. Dealio.
There you go.
Well, that was 60 grand just up the wall. That was good fun, isn't it? Oh, good. Enjoyed that one.
We can come to yours tomorrow.
What are we doing with downstairs? I don't know. It's a storeroom at the moment. It's fine. I'll use it to hide my Luke Combs ticket.
I think we are going to need some Luke Combs ticket storage at some point for this company.
We need more dartboards as well.
And Lighthouse family ticket. And fucking Tommy Trucker.
Tommy Trucker.
Oh, Hootie and the Trucker Fish.
Are you free in the morning, really?
Yeah.
Do you want to drive to Chester and surprise her? Oh, she's 32.
That's the thing as well. If we just
fucking
turn
Benjamin
up,
Button in my wife, she's at least 38. She's 38.
If we just turn up, she'll invite us in. You'll invite us in.
I'm not going to refuse you entry.
Exactly. So we can just do this against your will.
Yeah, the whole of the podcast is outside. Just hide. Close the curtains.
Do you know why he's letting you in? Kids, right. Aren't they?
Oh, yeah. Oh, you've got to be gone by the time they get back. We're not ready for that. Oh, my God.
You should actually do this.
Is she 38 tomorrow?
My kids would lose their fucking minds if you're all... They would love it so much.
Well, then why are you resisting this?
Yeah, come round then.
We'll come round at 5.
Come round. I do just want to have a quick phone call.
No, it's not a surprise if she knows,
is
it? I
know.
5 o'clock.
Where does a surprise become a shock? You've just... There's a line. Hey, it's a surprise.
Just make sure she's dressed.
What?
We'll come at 5 o'clock. She'll be dressed by then, surely.
Yeah, she tends to be.
Tell her you're taking her out on a romantic date. Tell her to put her best like glad rags on. And then at 5 o'clock, be like, actually, we're staying in and look in the garden. And we'll all be there with all of our
having
friends.
Having a beer. All right.
Dan can't say no anymore because he's been a tight cunt in the past. Here we are.
Would you rather go at midday or the end of the day?
Honestly,
5 o'clock, does that work for you? Because you can meet the kids for the first time.
3 o'clock. 3 o'clock. Come for the school pickup. I don't think that's allowed. I don't think I can take 9 lads and 2 cameras.
Can we come at 5?
Martin on sound.
Half 3.
I think there is some sort of
safeguarding. Are you back by half 3?
Yeah, the kids will be home and
I'll spend money on the business card.
They
buy loads of balloons and that.
Love new people, by the way. It would be immense.
Oh, they love me. Hey, Carl.
Adam's the newest they're gonna get.
Yeah.
Who the fuck's that?
I'm telling you right now, Jack will know who Adam is.
Will Jack say, have you been at the podcast?
Maybe, but Etta knows you.
Will Jack say podcast? You've met.
What? Oh, he says podcast. Yeah, yeah.
We've been at podcast.
Where you been, Dad? Podcast.
Well, we'll bring balloons. We'll make it obnoxious.
Yeah. Can you not swear for 2 hours? Is that all right?
Why the fuck would that matter?
It's got a little rule we have in our house not to call anyone a cunt in front of my small children.
Are they swearing in front of your
kids? So I can't call anyone a cunt in front of your kids. Can I call them a cunt to their face?
I think you're being
a little cunt here. Stop crying.
That might ruin the surprise of her birthday.
No, she'll get a surprise. We're at the end. It's 2 hours later. We're all blathered.
Are we drinking?
I think I'm going to a sober birthday party.
Oh, right.
With children there. You're having a laugh at you. I'm going to drink on the way. Pre-drinking this.
100%. And she'll love it. And we'll... Please don't tell her, though.
I feel sweaty.
If we turn up with balloons and fun things, she'll be happy.
And she's like, oh, I've been expecting you. No. I want, like, shock and awe.
And can we have a camera?
You're going to get it. you're going to get it.
Can we have a camera?
To film it?
That's what you usually do with cameras, yeah?
Yeah. And my kids... No, and where's this going?
The kids will be blared out like they've just done something naughty.
Like they're in witness relocation.
Like they're in Japanese porn.
Nice. I prefer mine.
Will you be busy tomorrow? What? Oh, he's got so much blaring to do. Yeah, we do things that need blaring a lot.
Oh, it's been fun, this, hasn't it? It's been fun, this. They're talking about the Reformation.
It will be in your house tomorrow.
So I'm not allowed to tell her.
Do not tell her. Don't be like...
But can't tell her that she's going on a fun... Like, get your glad rags on. That's not a...
If we turn up and she's in her fucking sweats and pyjamas, she's going to hate you forever.
No.
She's going to be like, oh my God, you planned me a surprise party. Everyone's all turned up in the tuxedos and I look like shit.
You're in tuxedos?
Yep.
Tuxedo is it black tie?
He's coming as well. What you should do is...
What did you hear?
Take it out and then come back so she's red. She's dressed from being out.
Right.
You know what I mean? Take it out at midday. Take it to, like, I don't know, McCooley's.
And then when she goes to get changed, when you get back, go, no, keep your clothes on. There's something coming. But that's as far as you can go. Oh,
it's right, not right, me. Right.
Yeah. No, keep those clothes on, love. The boys will be here soon. I mean, your surprise will be here soon.
Still told us surprise.
The boys. What do you mean? Shut up. Stay in your ball gown and shut the fuck up. This is your fucking birthday and you're ruining it. Now stay in your lavish ball gown. Stop asking questions about who's just turned up on the drive in your van. What do you mean you didn't want Jack Finnegan here on your birthday? Are you mad?
Yes, that is the Wenger boys outside booming the noise, but just shh.
Didn't want Harry Robinson in a fucking tuxedo.
I'm telling you right now, if she's in her gym jams and she turns up and she realises she's having the party of the year for her birthday and she hasn't been given the opportunity to get dressed for it, she's gonna resent you for a long time.
Yeah, that's on you.
What a birthday this girl's having. A fit bit of fisting, McCooley's, and a black tie party. At 3:30.
3:30.
Back from the school run.
Dan, what can we buy?
She'll have to do in a ball gown.
What can we buy it as a company? We'll get balloons and that. That's nice.
Balloons? We'll get her some birthday cake.
We get her a cake?
Yeah. Mugs. You know what they like.
What else does she want? Does she want to have a new lawnmower or something?
Huh? You know? I'll take one. I think she does, yeah. She wants a brand new
How's
lawnmower.
How's your kettle?
It's kettling.
I got Will a big shop once for his birthday.
Yeah, that was insane.
But he was fucking
I remember being there for that. It was Will's friends who just couldn't quite get their head around it.
Yeah, I drove to Manchester. I went to Tesco and spent like £100 on a big shop and then just gave it to him in a pub.
I seem to remember some like really nice cheese within there.
I got him a whiskey. He had cereal on his night out with whiskey in it.
Yeah.
A big shop. Big shop's a boss, mate.
Yeah, do a big
and
shop.
And someone buys one for you. I'm not doing you a big shop. You have fucking two kids. Froobs are 40 quid now. Much stupid.
Well, they're more expensive than whiskey. That's the cost of living for you. That's why we don't give our kids whiskey anymore. It's just the cost.
I'm excited for this.
Content. Can't wait. Oh, is anyone else sweaty? God damn.
Quite insane, yeah.
I'm excited.
Are we going to get her for a birthday?
We should get a certain joint.
A joint? Get her some pot.
Finn? I'm on it.
I thought you meant like a leg of lamb.
Pot.
All right. Yeah, she loves weed. Particularly when she's looking after the kids.
Does she like meat?
Tell you what, that's what we'll do. We'll turn up, party, everyone's getting bladdered, and I'll do a full roast dinner.
I'm not... Now you are getting more in the realms of, like, she'd love it. But I've seen how you leave kitchens post-roasts.
I'm not cleaning it up.
She can clean it. He cooked it.
Nice. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And she can just leave it till the next day and then it's not a fucking birthday and she can shut up moaning.
Yeah, yeah. God, she's so annoying.
I'll take the kids for the walk.
Do you know what? Through this whole thing, she's just been yap, yap, yap.
I'll take the kids for the walk around the red wreck.
What's that?
It's in Cardi.
Nice. Whew, we're going to have a break now. I'm going to have a little bit of a panic attack and then we'll come back. All right. Hello, everyone. Time to tell you about our very favourite sponsor, Manscaped.com.
Manscaped are our OG sponsor, and as you know by now, they do the very best in male grooming, especially when it comes to those things below your waist, your boys, your bollocks, your hairy little balls, okay? You want to shave them, keep them nice and neat, a little bit of stubble down there maybe, and you will get sucked off on a more regular basis. Isn't that right, Dan?
Oh, yeah. I'm always getting sucked off because I've got shining balls. Over 10 million men worldwide trust Manscaped to de-hair their bollocks.
The Lawnmower 3.0 Plus, the 4.0 Pro, and the 5.0 Ultra. They're all available. There's package deals you can get, and you get 20% off and free worldwide shipping with the promo code WORD20. So go to manscaped.com right now. Use the promo code WORD20. Get your 20% off and your free worldwide shipping. It is the best male grooming products you can buy. And it's not just the shaving stuff. There's deodorant for your bollocks and there's undies and that.
Summer's here. All sorts you can get. Summer's here. No one needs hairy balls in the summertime.
You're going to shave your dog, aren't you? So shave your cock as well.
Manscaped.com. WORD20. Do you know what everyone should do? Sign up to our Patreon, Adam.
Yeah, probably.
One of the biggest patrons in the UK.
Probably.
Patreon.com/haveawordpod.
So much stuff over there. Hundreds of thousands of hours.
Oh, we're doing hyperballs. There's hundreds of episodes, 40 specials.
Yep. The specials are worth like £3 each, never mind. £3 to get access to all of them.
Brand new special out Friday that's just come out, the art special. Which was incredible. It was a lot of fun, a lot of good.
Didn't we all do well? A lot of money raised. Proud of us that night.
I did well.
Same.
Really well. Yeah. the lock-ins, Nashville,
Amsterdam, Spain. We've been.
When people say the best thing about the Patreon is we know how good it is because when people sign up, they don't leave.
Yep.
They're just and it's the best stuff we put out. We know there's people now who actually stopped listening to the public episodes and just listen to the Patreon episodes and the. Yeah. And the specials because they're just the best stuff.
Don't you see the amount of people who are doing
26,000 lids cannot be wrong.
They can't be. Just think like, oh, if that many people are paying for it, then clearly it is worth it. And it is.
No guests today, just us fucking beauts. Now, top fives were popular to a point. We're going to change it up a little bit and we're going to start doing the tier system.
Tier list. Tier
I don't
list.
Know how this works. You're going to have to educate me.
Have you ever seen a tier list online, Adam?
Yeah, it's like God tier.
So,
sick tier.
I'm going to show you on the screen now. This is our tier list. So, S is the best that you can get.
Yeah, can we change this?
What does S stand for?
I'm going to change this to like pod references.
We talked about that. Do you want to
what does
that?
S stand for?
Like special.
I in my head, it's super, but I'm super. Not sure if it is.
And I
think it needs to be God tier.
So we can like change
that's
that.
The ultimate, isn't it?
So if, this
if
is
you
God
see
tier.
The, if you see this tier list and think, I can think of some pod references that can change them, comment below, please.
I think A should be dead good.
Dead good.
Dead good.
Yeah.
Dead good.
And B can just be, yeah.
No, B is like sound.
Yeah.
Oh, sound. C's, yeah.
C's like,
meh. C's a bit poo.
Yeah. And D is...
shite.
D's Freddie Quinn.
Oh, no. Freddie
Quinn. That's gone now. Freddie's no. Too fucking good, isn't he?
Yeah, but...
Shite.
Whoa. What?
No, that, it's wool to call it wool. You're not allowed to be in charge
that
way.
Was stinky, that.
Yeah. No, just, oh, you've ruined that.
Can we just have shite? Because that's what shite. We're trying for.
Bit wool.
Shite.
It's a bit wool, that. Coming over here from Will. Oh, let's put it all
from
in
Will.
Wool.
Coming Will. Over here from Will.
Yeah. Hello, Will.
Hi, Will.
You're a willy wool.
So this first one we've done is one-hit wonders. And I've tried to go for ones that everyone will know. I know Adam's musical knowledge ranges from Luke Combs to Chris Stapleton, so we've tried to find stuff in between that.
No, because before Adam was a country fan, Adam was a fan of songs.
Yeah.
So he knows what song.
I'm probably the best place to judge these one-hit wonders.
Okay.
Because I was a chart fucker until I found the Lord, you know? The way of music being country music. It's just, it's the best genre. You're all wrong. And Yeah. And everyone agrees with me as well.
Everyone.
Yeah.
Everyone. Apart from the loads of people who aren't asked about it.
It's the biggest genre on the planet at the minute.
That's not true.
It is.
It's not true.
Bigger than K-pop? Impossible.
What?
It's impossible.
That's over there. When I say the planet, I mean here in America. What are you talking about?
I thought you said here in America.
No, here.
He's gone.
America.
He's already in Tennessee.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Liverpool,
UK and America
Tennessee,
is the planet. And then everyone else is just over there, aren't they?
Yeah, Estonian country music doesn't really count, does it?
No. How would that go, Carl?
I'm going to make you a new pavement pathway in the front of your house.
Our famous Estonian workers. It's good.
Nah, aren't they good workers?
I can't move for Estonians around, are we?
I mean, there's not been much migration, but I'm guessing they're hard workers, grafters at least.
I think you might be right, because I think when most people hear, hello, my name's Jeff, they think Polish.
Yeah.
But it could be Estonian. You don't know who the Baltics are. Exactly. Lithuania, Latvia, they all sound...
You?
Yeah, they're all hard work, all grafters.
All of them.
All slinging shite. Yeah. All grafters.
They're all selling pathways.
Right.
Do you know that Scousism? Grafter, as in someone who sells drugs.
I just graft as in hard work.
No, no, it means you sell drugs. No.
A grafter in Liverpool is like sells drugs. Oh, my fellow do are. He's a grafter. Drives a Merc. Yeah. Got a G wagon.
That's a good grafter, that.
The Grafton wagon.
Should a graft phone.
All the drug dealers I knew had like Honda Civics and
yeah, don't,
a kid
don't
in the
be a grafter and drive a G wagon.
Honda Civic.
Have a focus.
Got some keto toyed.
Oh, shit.
There isn't a drug dealer in Liverpool who drives a Honda Civic. That is a fact.
Drug dealer or someone who's like, there's differences, isn't there?
If you've got a G wagon, you can't do drop-offs in a G-Wagon.
There's no one doing the drop-offs in a Honda Civic.
They all do it
you
in like Delta Joey's, like Focuses.
You fucking noob. Mate, they drive shitty cars.
Oh, you don't know what
And they've got like the NAM.
If you order some lounge, he orders a G-Wagon turned up. The police would be like, I think he sells drugs.
No, if I was driving a G-Wagon and I was a drug dealer and I got stopped, I'd be like, this is an illegal search and I'm not having it. I'd drive off.
Oh, you drive off. And that's how that works. Oh, Jay-Z. Well, he's moving now. We can't stop him. Yeah, we're going to bring the sniffer dogs. Well, yeah, if they can chase the car, because I'm flying.
Yeah.
Right. So that's it, drug dealers. If you're selling drugs and you get stopped by the police and you've got 3 kilos of drugs, I mean, what kind of drop-off were you doing? Just keep driving, because they can't stop you. That's the law. Isn't it?
No one is more bound by the law than police officers. So just go through a red light. They can't go through a red light because then when they chase you through a red light, you go, "Whoa, I'll arrest you."
You're under arrest.
You went through a red light, mate.
I've got 3 kilos of heroin in the back, but you went through a red light.
Just
so
say they planted it on you.
We're both in prison.
There you go, fact.
Your word against theirs.
That's yours. Your that does my head, and that with the police. Why have they become, is it omnipotent, omniscient? Which one
they're
is it?
They're omnipotent and and benevolent. They're God.
No, when their word against yours.
Put that in God's here, the busies.
Their word, you could go, I didn't do that.
What?
You say you've got drugs in the car and they go, they're yours, and you go, they're yours. Why do they win?
Because they're police officers.
Exactly.
Yeah, but the police have got a history of being pig scum, haven't they? So
yeah, but people who have 3 kilograms of heroin have got a pretty poor reputation as well. He's just a fucking grafter.
But if it's your first time getting caught,
Estonian.
What's more likely than me, an honourable local businessman?
In a G-Wagon with 3 kilograms of heroin?
Oh, yeah, I've just started selling drugs out of nowhere, have I? And I'm not just like running me 7 laundrettes like I have done for years. But this police officer, if he's got anything less than a spotless record, he should get put in prison for doing heroin.
Just go, hot potato. You're carrying them. Not even mine.
Those two in my head, another third, where they could just go, you did. You did punch that woman.
They're officers of the law, aren't they? That's how it's got to, who, otherwise who's in charge
it should all be
of
cameras.
The law?
We should all just do a vigilante. It should just be like we should all just do it amongst ourselves. Disband the police. We don't need them.
Right. Cool. Just disband them.
Disband them.
Yeah.
Steve was in a fender bender this morning. He didn't ring the cops. He sorted it out himself.
No, he's got some fake details and then he's going to phone no one. Steve's going to be trying to get money off a fender bender from Flirt Divert.
Hello, it's Steve. Can I have that money?
Yeah.
Go on, one-hit wonders.
Should we do it? Yeah, we're doing one-hit wonders.
Put the police in the shite here. The band, though.
Right, so the first one we've got is 7 Years by Lucas Graham. Do you remember this? This is from like...
Once I was 7
exactly.
Years
oh, that one.
My mama told me. It's not the first verse that's the problem for
that's
me.
That's what I wanted to
it's this. It, Lucas Graham's it only really had one.
Like, name his other song.
and Blue Dabadee. I'm talking like them Bonnet Wonders.
Whoa!
Have you got
I'm on 7 years, Lucas Graham. He's absolutely a banger.
It was his only number one.
It's a banger.
It's a one-hit wonder.
Have you got Blue Dabadee by I465?
Can you add it to the list for the ADHD kids?
Yeah, but that's whatever. What one-hit wonder is. That's like...
Hang on. You can't say Lucas Graham is not a one-hit wonder. Everyone knows it. It was a hit. He's done nothing since. That is a nailed on one.
But it can't be getting in this above Blue Dabba Dee Dabba Da.
It's not above anything. It's just in the list.
It's in the list and Blue Dabba Dee Dabba Da Dabba Dee isn't.
The list. Kate, accept the list. No, I'm not changing your fucking list.
I'm not fucking accepting it. Have you got Mamma Number 5? I've got Mamma
Number
5.
Oh, you've shaved. We've let a music go through it. You'll have some kind of
fuck off. Oh, well,
the coral.
Accept the fucking list. It's happening. Whether you like it or not.
The feature. It's in shit. The feature is 45 seconds old and you cunts are drowning it. No, it's wrong. Blue Tabati.
This one was your idea.
Yeah, a bit of song.
Fucking accept it.
I'm 7 years, where's it going?
Lucas Graham, the second verse.
Do you want the lyrics, Dan? Let me find the lyrics.
Once
for you.
I was 11 years old,
does he keep
my papa
up
told
ages?
Me, yes. Go get yourself a wife or you'll be lonely. What? Who? Which dad is saying that to an 11-year-old?
So hang on, what age does he end on?
He goes the future. Soon I'll be 60 years old.
Oh, shite. Put it in meh.
It is in meh. It's definitely in meh.
It's I like
Mambo
it.
Number 5's in meh.
Do you know what? I kind of like.
So I'd have gone for sound. I wouldn't have gone any higher than sound.
I like Lucas Graham.
What are you
I think
for,
it's
Dan?
A good song. It is. It's an earworm. And it the lyrics.
They're all going to be earworms. They won it wonders. They all did well.
Some of the lyrics like connect, and then they also. A deeply irritating.
Would you put it on in the
because
car?
Soon you will.
I don't
be
mind. I don't mind this song. I think it's a decent song.
Would you ever go to your Spotify or you're probably Apple Music, aren't you? Or
Etta likes this song as well.
Dan's
so
Amazon
potential.
Music.
No, I'm not. I'm Spotify.
Oh,
no,
you've
moved me.
Oh,
over.
Right. Okay.
But you wear Amazon Music. That is fucking
because I had an Alexa.
You and Jeff Bezos, the only two fucking.
This was one of the 7 songs they had on Amazon Music.
Just right. Shut the feature down. I hate this. Where's Blue Dabadee? Yeah, fucking spanners.
Right, so it's either going in sound or meh.
Put it in sound.
Yeah?
Have it in meh, but whatever.
By the way, these can move.
Yeah.
Yeah, if everything malleable. Above it looks better, yeah. It's going down. I'll give you that.
The next one we've got is Last Ketchup.
Oh.
Right.
I'm meh.
That's shite, eh?
It's a banger, though.
Is that it?
Even the song Living La Vida Loca.
Can you not live in La Vida Loca?
No, because it's not a one-hit wonder.
Oh, no, he's
oh yeah, more than one. Yeah. Can you give me Last Ketchup? Because I've forgotten.
I said, I have a
but it's shite, innit?
It's around the pool in Spain, innit?
You would never put that song on.
No, but if it came on, I'd go, way,
for about 5 seconds, then you'd be like, oh,
if you were 11,
no, he'd start singing Ricky Martin, because that's all he's got in his head. Oh, my God, it's Last Ketchup.
Put it in meh.
It's shite.
If you're leathered in pop world, this is the kind
Last
of stuff
ketchup.
You want to hear.
No, it isn't.
If you're 11 in pop world.
You're leathered.
We're all losing our virginity tonight.
It goes absolutely in shite for me.
I don't care enough what the song to bother, so if he wants to go in shite, I can't.
Let's go with a tier system. Carl's just there. Going, I don't care about him for the game.
I don't see that for shite. Dan?
It is kind of shite. Are we? What's the judgment on like
is it a good song?
They've all done well as songs.
There are some good songs in here that you would consider a good song.
Because is it a bit like is it subjective? Like if you know it's a bit crap, but you kind of like it anyway.
Mambo Number 5.
Or are we being more objective? Like this is technically and
Mambo Number 5 isn't a very good song. If it came out now, I'd be arsed. But it's come on.
You're going for shite?
I think it might be shite.
Shite. It's in the next one. Chesney Hawkes, the one and only.
I think that. Like, I don't love it, but I think by definition of One It Wonder, it's a God tier.
It's the epitome of One It Wonder.
It goes straight to God. It's got to, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's the epitome of this tier list.
It's what this game is built on.
This and Rick Astley, they are God. Fact.
Yeah. They both just have to
go. I think Rick Astley have another?
Yeah, Rick Astley's not in it.
He had a couple, though, didn't he, Rick Astley?
I think he's maybe just snuck out, but...
But Chesney Hawkes.
Chesney Hawkes is going God tier.
I don't like the song enough to get sticking God tier.
But it's what the whole thing is. Like, if you say One It Wonder, you think of Chesney Hawkes, like, immediately.
Yeah.
If you say it 3 times in a minute, he turns up in the house and sings it to you.
It's just an easy way to book him.
It can move, but I
think
it's
not
the epitome of One It Wonder.
Okay, all right. Right, the next one is Nizloppy with the JCB song.
Dead good.
It's such a lovely song, yeah. Man.
I bruise off of my dad's Bruce Lee. It's the same fella who pitched the Matrix.
You must be into this, Dan. It's a bit of you, this.
Yeah. Holding up the bypass. Whoa.
Can you sing it to me?
Me and my dad having a chop laugh. Whoa.
Sitting on a toolbox. Whoa. And I'm so glad I'm not in school, boss. So glad I'm not in school.
And I'm Bruce, I'm father, my dad's Bruce Lee. Drives me around in his JCB. I'm Bruce, I'm Luke. My dad's Bruce Lee.
I'm Bruce.
And my dad's Bruce.
I'm Luke.
And his dad's Bruce.
Who's this by? And what is he doing now?
Nizloppy.
Can we get a bit of information on Nizloppy?
Such a lovely fucking song.
Nizloppy. Are they still going?
Is it a band?
Yeah, they are still going.
They've just done the JCB song.
Yeah.
This is the tragic thing about being a one-hit wonder. You make a bit of bank, and then for the rest of your life...
It's tragic, but
someone's going, we do that shitty song. And then you try and do another song, and no one gives a fuck.
Finn did it for the year, didn't he?
I did.
It has to go at least in Dead Good.
It's such a lovely song. Mm. You'd love that song.
I know it. Yeah. I'm just not.
Should we go Dead Good?
Yeah,
I agree with that.
It's a beautiful song.
Right, Nizloppy's going
in
Dead
Good. It has to go in Dead Good because you're not putting that alongside Lucas Graham. They're the same.
This is where they start moving.
I can't believe that Lucas Graham song is getting absolutely no.
I wouldn't be able to tell you his name.
I think it's quite good. It's a decent song. The next one is, I think there's going to be two people who are going to want this in God's ear. This is the Rembrandts, I'll Be There For You.
Are they technically a one-hit wonder though with all the paintings they did?
Oh, yeah. That's next week's One It Wonder Paintings.
Salvador Dali, yeah. Surely, the clocks.
Love it when you do it.
It's God tier.
No, it's not.
Is this there?
What are you talking about?
It's not up there with Chesney Hawks.
Sing the second verse.
It's
what?
Sing
it's,
the second verse.
This is on performance enhancing steroids because it's a theme tune.
Yeah,
otherwise,
sing the
it's
verse.
Not a big and it's.
Still in bed at 10 and work again at 8. Shook my dick and put it in God tier.
Shook it.
It's the title track. For the most successful TV show of all time, and everyone knows the claps in it. Never mind the lyrics.
But that's not the song. It's just Friends. Friends is making it God tier.
Yeah, but if it came on in part, well, so it would go off, wouldn't it?
If Friends is attached to it, it matters to its legacy. If this came on, you're talking about Popwell before. This goes off in any bar on the planet. When the night Chandler died, like I was walking around town, and you just walking past bars, and people were just playing it. In memory of a fella who just died like an hour ago, it is God tier. It goes straight
he
to God tier.
He hated it.
And I am dying on this hill. I'll quit the podcast.
I don't care enough for this one again.
Carl, even if you don't care, pretend to.
No, I do care, but I'm not like, this needs to be shite or good. I'm like, go for it.
So you think it's sound?
I put it in Dead Good.
Dan, where are you putting it? It's got to be a majority.
I would rather have the passion. Let's put it in
God
tier.
That's what I'm saying.
Okay, we're going God tier. Right, next one, the one we've all been talking about. Mambo number 5, where's it going?
Donny Blue Baker. Why are you asking us?
What do you mean?
Talking about?
Where do you put it?
God.
Really, yeah?
It was the example we gave on a good one before we knew what the tier list was.
Yeah,
to be honest, Con, I just don't care enough. It is a
if you're
bit of a banger.
Yeah, do, everyone going,
I'd be like, Ricky Martin. Mambo number 5.
Is that Ricky Martin singing Mambo number 5?
This is, by the way, is the Cha-Cha Slide in this?
No.
Fucking hell, mate. Mambo number 5 for me has to be God. It is the first 5 seconds of that, everyone goes, banger.
Did Mambo number 5 do bits all around the world?
I want to say,
was
so,
it
yeah.
just the UK or was it? Is it
no,
international?
It's definitely.
By the way, you know,
America
New Baker.
Well.
I don't know whether we spoke about this on pod. You know how young he is. You know he's still like only like 29 or something.
We were
then
the real
we
going out.
Then
10
he was
years
4
ago.
Years old when he brought this out.
He's a lot younger than you think.
That's an international.
My days,
absolute smash.
That is a number one. Apart from in Go Down. Who didn't go for it?
No, that's just
it's
God
tier.
Shit everywhere.
It's God tier.
America came
oh,
third.
Oh, no.
Everywhere else.
Hang on. Sweden weren't keen.
Ricky Martin.
No, that's the end of the year chart. That's the end of the year chart.
So the weekly
chart. The weekly charts.
It did
number
one
everywhere apart from America.
Give me God tier for that, please.
Do you know what? That's hard to disagree with.
Yeah, that is an international
banger. Can you see how long Lou Bega is, please? If he's anything less than 60, Adam, I'll give you it. But
he's definitely under 60.
He's 49.
Oh, wow.
I told you.
That is a bit mad.
Wow, that is interesting.
When did Man Bone Number 5 come out? 20 years ago?
No, hang on. That's not that. So he was in his 20s.
When 1999.
25 years ago. So he was 24 when it came out.
24 when he had a number one on every planet.
Unbelievable. Remarkable. I mean, it's a miracle he could walk at 24.
You're going
still in his shorts. So
it's God tier, is it?
Yeah, it is.
Yes, you're still in his shorts.
Oh, he hasn't got
some still in his shorts and walking.
Still in his shorts, you know. And he was nappy trained at 24. It's a fucking genius. God,
you can't be number one in every country in the world and all the universe and not be in God tier.
Okay, so here's my issue, because this was the one I was going to bat for God tier, which is Goat Ye, somebody that I used to know. I think
what
this
are
is the
you
best
on
song
about?
On the whole
told
chart.
Told you we're giving him a goth.
Goat Ye is somebody...
This is the definition of it. This is like another definition of it, yeah. But I think the song is also okay.
Nah,
it's
a great
song.
I think also it was made better by the video.
The music video is
the
amazing.
Lady that sings it is very Kimbra. Attractive. She's very... Kimbra?
Yeah.
Kimbra.
I'd make that... personally, that's dead good. That's very similar to the JCB song.
That doesn't go into God tier.
Has God tier done it?
He was just a mildly successful... It was like... let's try and think of
someone. Say the joke.
If like James Morrison suddenly had an absolutely unbelievable massive hit now.
Finn, say the line.
Huh?
Just say the line.
Oh, Goat Ye is now somebody that we used to know.
That's
all you wanted.
Dead good. Dead good. It's not God tier, it's just not.
Right, how many views has it got on YouTube?
I'm going to say 750 million.
I don't know.
Billions?
Yeah.
6 billion?
2.2 billion. Yeah.
It's a very famous video as well, isn't it?
That must be heartbreaking for him when his second song's got like 25,000.
Mm. Oh, this is like fourth album for him. This is just a random song that's blown up.
Oh, wow.
And he only got to number 33 in Honduras, so shite.
Why have they got so many songs? Oh, they got all the songs, haven't they, I suppose?
Yeah.
I tell you who was number one in Honduras, Lou Bega. that talented child.
It can't go into God tier. Also, we're just going to end up with a full God tier and then three in shite. Like,
I was going to bat for it God tier. I'll accept dead good, though.
I think it's got to be dead good.
Yeah, it is just dead good.
I think it's very similar to the JC.
I actually think it's closer to sound than dead
oh,
good.
Oh, no, it's to too good a song. It's so good.
Yeah, I'm giving you dead
this
good.
This is the best song on the list.
It's very solid when it is.
Right, next one. Charles and Eddie, Would I Lie to You?
Don't God you tier. Know it's true?
What? Absolutely,
you mong. How are you?
I know it.
Can't
I like
say
it.
That.
I can't. I'm bringing it back. You deserve it. Goat Ye's, I'm fucking average. Never liked it. 2.2 billion numbers. Charles and Eddie,
oh, yeah.
God tier.
Don't you know it's true? No one else but you. Would I lie to you,
baby?
That's a well better song than that shite that he was.
I think it's the top of Dead Sound.
Dead Sound. That's not even one of the tiers, Cal.
Dead good. I think it's the top of dead good.
Listen, I'll give you that.
It's not a bad song.
It's the top of dead
good. But the fact we've been so dismissive about Gautier and like, Charles and Eddie, I fucking live and breathe. I'm going to see them at the cathedral in Rochdale.
I'd go and see Charles and Eddie.
Of course you would. Rochdale one Catholic Cathedral. Get there. Tickets are fucking expensive because I've made it up.
I play that in the car in the tour bus.
Pretty
quite
sure
often.
Charles and Eddie is dead.
I don't know. I think Adam might be the kiss of death for the actual review of these songs. Oh my God. Were they gay?
No, I don't
Why
think
is that
so.
A problem?
Well, I just want to know. I'm not judging.
Will that change where you put it?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, Charles is dead, guys, so we can't see him.
Yeah, what's Eddie up to?
He's just vibing, you know?
Was Eddie and Charles a couple? Oh my God.
Where?
Yeah, no, but that's not how they've written it.
Oh, I think they were.
They was.
So where's this one
top
going?
Of dead so my opinion top of dead good.
There is no top of dead good, there's no, just
no,
dead good.
No, but you also ranked them within that. You can't.
All right, okay.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll give you that.
So it's going dead good.
It is listen.
The top of it, please.
It is a belter.
Drag it to the end.
What?
There you go.
Okay.
Oh, I see what you're doing. Yeah.
Right. Next one is Carl Douglas with Kung Fu Fighting.
It's a banger, isn't it? But
it is. It probably has to go in. See, I think it goes in meh, but I also think Lucas Graham has to go right alongside it as well.
When Bruce Lee died, I walked through town.
Hurry up and finish because we're done now. He's won. Finish. It's over. We're done.
I'm voting for meh. Anyone else?
No, it's gotta be in there. It's that good.
Hey, what are you on about? Oh. Get done.
Pot wailed again. It's like, oh.
No,
it's
no, it does. It goes in meh, and you could make maybe an argument to Sam.
It's not
that song.
That's not that. Everybody was kung fu fighting. Yeah. What are you on about?
Everybody was kung fu fighting. She'll make you take your gi off and go dancing in the rain. How we were fucking so fuming about the feature. I've never seen all of us give a shit about something so much.
It's in meh.
I agree.
Oh,
meh.
Okay, I'll let you have it, but I love that song.
I don't even know. Dead cunt.
Yeah. So it's the same as Lucas Graham.
No, it's
No, come on.
That's bad shite.
It's going in there.
I agree with you on Lucas Graham should be down there as well. I'm telling you, right, we're all going to fall out on this last one, by the way.
We've got one more.
What is it? I don't know what it is.
It's Daniel Powter.
It's one of our favourite songs.
Daniel Powter, Bad Day.
All around the... Is that it?
No.
No?
You had a bad day.
Take him one down. You sucked the dog off.
I'm singing one.
Came in your mouth.
You were doing Mad World.
I think this is the same as
the... Wonder.
I don't...
It was.
I think
that was nearly made the list.
Mine and Adam's version's God tier.
Can't do that on air, though, can we?
No.
This goes in sound.
Do you reckon? I'd go for that good for this.
Because you had a bad day.
I don't think it's as good a song as any of those three in Dead Good. So it has to go in sound.
I'm not a massive fan of this song, to be honest.
You think it's better than two of them?
Yeah, I think it's better than Charles and Eddie Anderson.
You're a fucking charlatan.
I also think it's better than all three of the God tier ones. It's a better song.
But that... You're in Pop World and Lou Baker comes on and then this comes and you're like, whoa, I had a bad day.
I like it as a song. It was on my playlist years ago. I do like it, but I just think it goes in sound.
For me, when I think of the epitome of your old taste in music, where you're like, it's now 62. Yeah. This is that.
Yeah, he liked songs.
Yeah.
So I think I put it in sound.
No better than sound.
Anyone have any objections to it going in sound?
I think it should be meh. But again, it's...
That is much better than that Lucas Graham shite you've never got off.
I know you like it more than Lucas Graham. I've got that.
Do you know what's happened here? Lucas Graham has fucked the whole equilibrium.
No, it's not. Yeah. It's not a bad song. It's a bit irritating, I'll give you that.
Right, I'm going to put it in sound.
All right.
Okay.
Are you putting it above Lucas Graham just to keep these children happy?
Yeah, we'll put it above Lucas Graham.
Oh, right. Lucas Graham's going nowhere, mate. Fuck you.
It's not moving. Oh, there we go.
Can I throw out some other ones?
Honorable
mentions.
I know you've
not got the graphic for it.
Yeah, I've not got the graphics, but yeah.
Honorable mentions.
Yeah.
Baby Cakes by Three of a Kind.
Shite.
Baby Cakes.
Great.
I just don't know.
Straight into shite.
Shite, yeah. It's such a banger.
If you got in my car and I had that on, you'd turn it off.
No.
I wouldn't.
I'd be like,
remember this
I've not heard this for ages. What a tune.
Yeah. What else?
DJ Pied Piper and the Master of Ceremonies. Do you really like it?
Do you really like it? Is it
dead good?
We're loving it.
Yeah, really good.
Dead good.
Ruby De Silva. Touch me.
Touch me in the morning and last thing at night.
Is that literally a one? Never heard that song. You have. Yeah, you definitely have. Is that a one-hit wonder?
What? You have to have heard Touch Me in.
And touch me in the morning.
I need your love.
You have heard it. I promise you've heard it.
You've heard it. Mad that. It's massive. I've already sung it three times.
Eiffel 65. Blue Dabba Dee is God tier. And the fact you didn't have it listed for this means you should be fired.
It'd be in shite for me.
Can I throw
I'll blow your head off.
Mr. Wazzo, Flat Beat.
Was that on the wireless in the 30s? Bum. What's this?
Who is Mr. Saxo Beat?
Alexandra Stan.
That's one as well.
So you'd put Blue Dabba Dee in shite.
Yeah, it's a shit song.
You are an idiot.
You're being baited by nostalgia.
Yeah, but that's what this is.
I know. And our nostalgias are all different because we're all different ages.
You were born in 2014.
Yeah, they're from a generation who thinks Lucas Graham's a paedophile. Yeah. And that is a fact.
He's not a paedophile, he's just shite songs.
Because he's been fucking all the kids.
Dan, you mentioned Mad World before.
Mad World was like the anti-Christmas number one, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And it's absolute shite. It might be the worst song that's ever done well. Familiar
faces. Usually the press, of course.
Yeah. I'm not saying I like it, I just know it.
And his name's Gary Jules, and I just ate it all.
I was born when a one-hit wonder was number one. Joe Dolce, Shut Up Your Face.
That was number one when you were born.
What's the matter, you?
Hey.
Gotta no respect. Hey.
I want to see man.
Shut up in your face.
I want to see what man.
Right, so let's read the tier out that we've got that's finished. And then if you want to send us in. Oh, no, we'll put it on socials. We'll put this graphic on socials and you can comment where you'd swap things about. So in shite, we've got Last Ketchup. In meh, we have Kung Fu Fighting. In sound, we've got Bad Day and 7 years. Dead good. We've got Would I Lie to You, JCB song, and Somebody That I Used to Know. God tier is the one and only I'll Be There for You and Mambo Number 5.
Seems about right.
Number one. I believe you asked me to sing the second verse of that song.
It did take you a second, though.
Because I was just making sure that wasn't the third verse.
Number one when I was born was Shakespeare Sisters, Stay. Banger.
Banger of a song.
Yeah.
99. Were you born in about
92.
Yeah.
Also, leave a comment on what tier lists you'd like us to do in the next few weeks and we will get around to
I've gone through the recent ones and I don't recognise them because I don't listen
number
to...
Number ones? Yeah,
like,
no.
One-hit wonders.
Yeah,
A, B, C, D, E.
Oh, that beat us in the lore has gone
chart. Jackson 5.
A, B, C, D, E, F, you and your mum.
Oh, yeah.
Can I also throw out... I took a gun... I don't care.
Yeah. I love it.
I love that one.
That's a decent one.
That's two Swedish birds. Oh!
Tattoo!
The lesbian Russians that are probably dead now.
Yeah. All of the things you said.
No, I think they run a pizza shop, you know, in Germany.
What?
I'm pretty sure they run a pizza shop.
Is this Cockney Neil?
That's the name of it. Yeah, Cockney Neil's pizza.
Russian lesbian pizza. Calm down. Calm down, fucking
it's called like tattoo pizza or something. In Germany, they just retired and live in Germany.
All the things you said.
Two lesbians.
He did.
That's God's here.
Again, that's the video that's helped it a lot, though.
Because yeah, there were fucking lesbians necking. You could spaff off to it at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. It's great.
You know what? Everything that he said, I absolutely agree with. Maybe I wouldn't have put it like that.
He was in school.
Yeah.
No, you get home early.
Why are you coming home, son?
That bell's for me, Adam.
TV on, girl.
Someone get Mr. Rowe off tattoo.
There is some we've missed out. Comment below if we've missed one of your favourite one.
Fucking loads we missed out because Finn didn't do it properly.
We were limited to 10.
Well done, Finn.
I missed some other ones out.
That was good.
Well done.
That is not only is everyone giving a shit in places, Carl. Everyone's giving a shit, but it's been funny and it's been good. That's good. Good work, Finn.
Comment below what
Let's
we should do.
Let's take this offline.
Yeah. What tier list should we do and what missed songs we've missed out. Comment below.
I'm not. You're gonna. I'm really argue that is the tiers. That is spot on. God tier, dead good, sound, meh, shite. You can't.
No comment below. As in, what he wants to do next.
Oh yeah.
Tier list. Sorry.
Have we got any preferences?
Trilogies, movie trilogies.
Oh.
I don't know. Something like that. Maybe. Movies. Something to do with movies or food or something that everyone knows.
And while we're here, Carl, Finn and Harry have been doing a film podcast.
Yeah.
That is on the Patreon as well. Just sign up to the
It's called Have
Patreon.
A Word. Charlie, do you want to grab? You're the host. It's called Have a Word Film Club.
Have a Word Film Club.
Yeah.
And follow us on Letterboxd.
Explain what we do.
We watch two films that we tell you to watch and then talk about them.
Yeah. By the way, if you watch it, there are spoilers.
it's a film review.
Commented that we'd ruined Moneyball, which is 14 years old.
And is a film viewer.
Is it 14 years old, Moneyball?
13, sorry, my mouth was off.
We will tell you what films to watch and then listen to what we think about them. It's a bit of a laugh. It's also good some good film knowledge, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's nice and easy. It's short, half an hour. Put it on the car driving to work. It's only available on patreon.com/haveawordpod.
And the next two are Civil War, which is in the cinema, and Four Lines.
They're the next two films.
All right, let's have a break.
What's happening, lads? Time to tell you about my absolute favourite sponsor. It's lovehoney.co.uk, and they've got a massive site-wide up to 70% off sale on until the 29th of April. And with the promo code WORD15, you'll get an additional 15% off. Unbelievable products like these, the Super Squeeze Vibrating Double Kegel Balls. Put them up a pussy and it'll be creaming in no time.
What about the 50 Shades of Grey Greedy Girl?
Oh my
God. G-Spot Rabbit Vibrator. Honestly, we've had a little... I wish I had a clitoris.
That bit goes on your clit. That one goes up and finds your G-Spot and you're just fucking... Oh, it's too much.
Everyone loves jizzing. Do it better with Love Honey. With lubes and toys and lingerie. They're award-winning for a reason. It's
and
the
little
best
sexy
shit.
Dress-up outfits as well. Get yourself a little French maid one and say, hey, love, dust the top of those cabinets while I bum your head off there. You know what I mean? Word 15, 15% off. On top of the already up to 70% off. Limited time only. It's until the 29th of April. Lovehoney.co.uk. Promo code is word 15.
Got a clear allergies, this.
Water. Telling you right now, water is underrated, mate.
Not to you.
By African villagers.
Well overrated.
It is underrated. It's fucking great. Like, you feel so much better if you drink more water, you know.
Squash.
Right, time to play, so.
That's just water with a bit of flavour.
We've talked about this. I don't drink actual water.
It's not called squash. It's called.
No, he's refilled it, hasn't he, with squash in it?
No, it's flavoured still water.
Adam's fancy. Right. I have refilled it with
no
squash.
Added sugar.
Right. There we go. Is underrated, overrated water.
I still think that Ronaldo thing was cool when he was like, get that shit off. Agua.
It's painful, isn't it?
I know, but it's still cool.
Yeah.
To be like, I don't give a fuck.
I think you can do that. This is worth as much as him. He gets the privilege of being able to tell.
Well, to just do the right, yeah.
Coca-Cola.
The thing is, before he did that, the CEO of Coca-Cola asked him not to, and he did it anyway.
What the fuck? And he likes 20 minutes of sun every day. So I imagine playing for Man United was fun.
Yeah. I think what Adam was alluding to was the...
Some allegations against him in America.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, sorry.
David Williams.
I haven't bleeped it.
You don't need to bleep that.
Why would I
bleep? I just remembered one of my favourite children's authors. Matt, just
Edith Blyton.
She's
been cancelled.
She's been cancelled?
She's been cancelled.
Blyton?
For being racist.
Oh, well, the statute of limitations. When was she racist? Last Tuesday?
In the 50s.
Oh, everyone. This is a national fucking pastime.
What? Blyton was racist in the 50s?
Some of her books have been seen to have racist undertones. Same with Roald Dahl. They're rewriting all the
I'm
Roald
sorry,
Dahl's books.
But back in the 50s, if the only racial problems your book had was undertones, you were fucking liberal, mate.
Progressive.
You can't rewrite Roald Dahl. Just don't read it or do a new one.
What is her? Hang on, I don't give a shit about Enid Blyton. Roald Dahl, yeah, you Roald say? Dahl.
Some nasty team.
No, come on. George's Marvelous Medicine.
Not that one.
The Twit.
I think it's mainly the witches, I think, is the one that's they're having a go at.
Kids think it's shit.
Let me have a look. There's an article.
I'm trying to remember what the witches...
Oh, no, sorry. I was wrong. Augustus Gloop is not fat anymore. He's enormous. Mrs. Twit is no longer ugly. And Oompa Loompas are gender neutral. This is in The Guardian.
Right.
I don't know if this is true, but I remember reading about it.
Finn, you cannot... Like, in that... Oh, Enid Blyton, dead racist. Roald Dahl... called a fat kid fat. I'm not having it. It's not even the same league of cancellation.
It's not me that's doing it.
Here you are. You're voicing The Guardian
right
now.
It's his generation, isn't it? I think Roald Dahl did quite well, to be honest with you, because he always took good criticism.
Cool. Uh-huh.
You know, the BFG wasn't originally the Big Friendly Giants. It was the Big Fat Gyaldem. And he changed it because he didn't want to be offensive.
It was
Big
a Fat Gyaldem.
Yeah.
Who's this coming in the night stealing dreams? La Quisha.
The Big Fat Gyaldem. Roald, you can't say that. What not?
And they went, you can't do that. And he was like, all right.
We need to change Yolanda to Bone Crusher. Ah, don't say it. It's not my original vision. Finn?
I was just reading about Enid Blyton. It's, that one is racist, so I won't read that one out loud.
Why? What did she say?
What did she do?
Bleep it.
Come on.
She probably wrote it, didn't she? She didn't say it.
Does it rhyme with Jolly Pog?
It's close.
Jolly Bones?
Yeah, it's close. It's close.
Do you remember playing with Jolly Pogs when you were a kid?
Yep. Oh. No. Crazy Bones, though.
That was the original Beyblade.
Hang on, can I see you?
Yeah.
Go on.
Go on. Like, how bad is it, Carl?
Oh, yeah, it's quite bad.
Right, okay, don't
what
read
is it? Give us a gist.
I'll just... Finn, you say that.
No.
But Augustus nice. Gloop was a big fat kid, though. Come on.
He was written as a fat kid.
It's a fat kid.
He is a fat kid.
By the way, I know you're not meant to say it, but if you go... It's no better to go up to a kid and go, hey, can I just say, listen, he's your kid, but that kid's enormous. She's still going to be like, wow. If you got fat, it's the same. It's still offensive, isn't it?
Why are you doing this in the park to random people?
Well, it was school. That was the school pickup.
Hey. Two little clones and your kid's enormous.
Hey, sorry, love. I don't mean to be offensive, but that kid's enormous. Anyway, I'm done, by the way.
That isn't offensive now, by the way. They can call him fat.
And the Oompa Loompas are gender neutral. Who needs that? Who wants it?
Did anyone care that they were men?
I think the point is that there's no representation for non-binary people in old school media. So they're like, we need to make someone gender neutral. And I think they've sort of sat at the negotiating table and Roald Dahl's like sort of estate have gone, right, we'll give you the Oompa Loompas and you can fuck off.
Wow.
Yeah, that's, he's paraphrasing it. That's pretty much what
a meaning.
You're not
that
having
is.
The BF Galdem.
Big fat Galdem.
Right, we'll give you...
She
we'll
can't
you
see the queen at the end of the film.
We give you 5 Oompa Loompas. Deal.
They're shaking hands. Photo, like,
they're not even orange anymore, are they?
Did you... Listen, are you...
No, Scousers has kicked off about that.
Are you Roald Dahl's Jana Rash on?
Oh, yeah. Quentin Blake. What a wonderful illustrator as well.
Oh, I love...
That was a match made in heaven, that one, eh?
Yeah. Oh, my God.
Was he a smackhead? Have you seen his sketches? I'm like... What did
that was just the style?
Did I know his style, but it works brilliantly. But if you said, oh yeah, Quentin Blake was a smackhead, you'd be like, oh yeah, I see it now.
Like, why?
What, and Picasso's just on LSD?
Because it's sketchy as fuck. It looks like he's like, oh God, I just need a hit. I think Roald Dahl owed him money. He was like, I'm drawing your fucking pictures, mate.
I love Quentin Blake stuff.
I love Quentin Blake, but it's not like, it's a very stylized... Like he's got the fucking withdrawal shakes.
Yeah, but that's his style. I love it. I'm not saying it's
that's
not good.
Just what art is. Everyone's individual. Like Picasso drew fucking like noses on asses and shit, didn't he? No one said anything about that.
Nope, they didn't. I mean, they did. They brought it up quite a few times.
He's smacking. What's this shit?
When he brought it out, they were like, hey, lad, is that a nose on that ass? He's like, yeah, I'm Pablo. Do things differently. I'm double P.
Yeah. Roald Dahl, Quentin Blake, match made in heaven. Unbelievable. They'd be gods here.
What, kids' books?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And the Miss, the men, and they've all changed now, haven't they? Little Miss, I don't know.
No, it's Little Miss.
Mr. Tickle's being phased out because of the Me Too movement. Yes.
He's Mr. Consent.
Yeah. Mr. Yes.
Or Mr. Can Tickle. I give you a hug?
Mr. Tickle just goes out and just doesn't do anything because things have changed.
Little Miss, I've got a job now.
Yeah, Little Miss, you know,
Little
chairman.
Miss, Little Miss voting booth.
For Fortune 500.
Yeah. Like they're all. I've got all the collection of the original.
Little Miss Foundry Worker.
I've got the originals. Little Miss and Mr. Mendo.
I can't remember what I was talking about or whether I seen something recently where someone was like, imagine if Pablo Picasso all that time was just trying to draw a normal face and he couldn't see the difference between the two. And he's kept just like, yeah, that is just, that's perfect, that.
Pelt of that nose on your ass.
Incredible style. You're like, what's that?
It's a false.
I'm trying to do it properly.
But Roald Dahl, I don't think you can change that.
I remember having the BFG read to me when I was a kid, and it was like the most magical story I've ever heard. And then watching my kids like watch the film, it's so cool that there's a land of giants. They give you dreams, or he gives you dreams, then they all eat kids, and then the queen gets involved.
What was happening?
What?
They all eat kids.
Yeah.
Yeah. I forgot that. I think I've blocked that out.
Right. Let's do Adam's films
get a list
for the BFG.
Of Roald Dahl.
Hang on.
I can't really remember it. I know, but there was a big fella and a little kid, and they were mates.
You're thinking of Big, the film?
No, is that the Tom Hanks one?
Yeah.
No, that's just a kid with like elephantitis, isn't it?
By the way, in Big, she fucks a kid.
Oh yeah. Oh shit. Of course she does, yeah.
She has sexual intercourse with a 9-year-old boy.
Yeah,
In Tom Hanks's.
But she didn't have to shag a 9-year-old for the film. She shagged Tom Hanks.
She shagged a 9-year-old for the film, that would be out of order.
She wasn't method.
No. That's why they cast Tom Hanks. Because otherwise they would have just gone and got a 9-year-old.
No, but he's a 9-year-old boy.
He's playing a 9-year-old boy.
Go on, Adam. All right. In the film,
yeah.
I know the actress. who went on to do fucking something else.
Michelle 9/11. Pfeiffer.
9/11. She did 9/11.
Michelle Pfeiffer did 9/11. With Sally Gunnell.
Where's Sally Gunnell did 9/11 from? Did I say it?
You said that 2 weeks ago. Yeah.
Elizabeth Perkins.
Perho.
Sounds like a brand of...
She was in the Flintstones.
Sounds like a brand of bras.
She was. She was Thelma.
Perky tits.
Was she? Mm. Oh. Mate, sexy cartoons. Are we doing that?
Can we give Adam... I want Adam's synopsis on...
Oh, the BFG.
BFG and others.
I can't... You're asking me to do a synopsis of a film. I can't really remember. So...
Giants and a kid. Wind it up.
I knew it was something to do with dreams, but...
He blows dreams into the thing, and then a kid sees him, so he has to take him back to Snozcumberland, eat Snozcumbers, because he's not a carnivore. All the other giants, Bone Crusher, I can only remember Bone Crusher.
Brock Lesnar,
Sally Gunnell, Abu Hamza, their mates. Love it if Sally Gunnell was mates with Abu Hamza.
Dennis Rodman.
Not another podcast on the planet, by the way. Who could say that sentence in context at any point?
James and the Giant Peach.
I honestly haven't seen any of this. Since I was a kid, so
The Witches. Have you seen the Witches films? Are classic.
Yeah, but I can't remember the film.
Oh, mad. Okay.
Like I know I've seen it, and I know the witches, and they all take the fucking hats off, and they all look like goblin women.
Yeah.
They've changed that now. I read that. They've added a bit after that that says. And women are allowed to be bald, and that is completely fine.
Yeah, because they're all like bald, aren't they? They all have
which is true.
Women can
but
be
I
bald.
Thought that's not the point of the characters,
I would say that
it?
Most people who are women aren't bald, though.
That's how inclusion works. You're right.
Most they should put that on the thing.
Yeah. Most women aren't bald.
It's okay for women to be bald, but most of them aren't, so remember that as well.
Also, Gail Porter seems all right, doesn't she? Yeah. She's sound.
It's quite a conversational... piece of text, this isn't it? What about Danny, Champion of the World? No,
that honestly, I think my least favorite one.
I don't remember that one.
And I was a kid called
I think
Dan.
I've got Alzheimer's, you know.
George's Marvelous Medicine was another one that just like, as a kid, that it was the most. He feeds his gran a load of shit that he finds in the garage, and she grows so much she goes through the roof. Quentin Blake's illustration. Makes it the most magical thing.
I'd love to be inside as like Roald Dahl's head. Someone like that who's got that much creation. Must be mad.
I mean, it's a pretty basic story, isn't it? This fella finds fucking growth hormones, gives it to his nan. Maybe it just happened to him when he was a kid.
Yeah. Yeah. When Roald Dahl was a kid, there was loads of growth hormone around the house. And pre-workout. And anabolic steroids.
I'll write about this when I'm older.
I'd probably, you know... I might not put this down in a notepad because I think this might be retellable. Is he Welsh, Roald Dahl?
No, I don't think so, is he?
Egyptian, isn't he?
I can't imagine Roald Dahl being Welsh.
He is Welsh.
What?
I thought he was like Austrian for some reason.
He's Welsh.
No, you're thinking of Joseph Fitzgerald.
He's called Roald Dahl.
That sounds Danish.
Dahl's not a...
Roald Dahl sounds Welsh. Danish.
Sounds Indian.
If you do it in a Welsh voice, it sounds more Welsh. It
sounds like a curry.
Brock Lesnar.
It sounds like a fucking curry. I'll have the chicken Roald Dahl, please.
Yeah, right. His dad was Norwegian.
Danish. Same
and his mum was French.
Welsh.
And he grew up in Wales.
He grew up in Wales.
He's been to Wales.
He grew up and died in Wales. He spent his whole life
in
Wales.
No, he died in Oxford.
Smoker.
Prick.
He's been to Wales once.
I've gone right off Roald Dahl. I thought he was a Welsh hero.
I fancy a lamb Roald Dahl, I do. And a garlic naan.
You know, you should never say naan bread.
Why?
Because naan means bread. You're saying bread.
You're saying bread.
Yeah. Can I have a bread?
Can I have the butter chicken, please, love? And some bread.
Yeah, if you say, can I have a garlic naan? No one in an Indian restaurant is like, I don't know, what is mad cunts on about? You're saying garlic bread.
So I would say garlic naan. I'll have a garlic naan, please. But if I wanted a plain one, I'd just say, can I have a naan bread? Naan.
Yeah, can you have a bread?
But also, a lot of the menus say naan bread. They don't just say naan.
I know, yeah.
So that's them, innit?
They've tailored it to us.
Yeah, I ate that. I fucking ate that where they go, oh, all these fucking people saying it wrong. You wrote it down. I'm just reading your handwriting, love.
I don't know what naan is until you told me what it was.
Yeah.
Tell me right the first time and I'll learn.
What's your naan of choice?
Garlic or... Yeah, no garlic.
So you're telling me Indians go do us a favour, nip to the shop and get us some naan, and those people come back with the war buttons?
Yeah. Yeah, that's because that's Indian bread, isn't it?
Nah, mate.
Nice sliced naan.
Yeah. Have we got naan in? Yeah.
Can you have a naan crisp butty?
Yeah. No, we've got naan. I like Peshwari. Does that make me a paedophile?
No, it doesn't make you have sex with children. No, is you eating it to do that?
Well, every time
is that what's making me shag kids?
Every time I
can have a Peshwari, will that make me a paedophile?
I fuck a fat kid, but I call him enormous to, you know, save hurting
if
his
I
feelings.
Put two and two together there, I'd stop eating them, to be honest.
I think it might be the coconut. That shit does weird
I
stuff.
I eat fucking kids and I'm eating Indians a lot. I'm just wondering about a link.
I'm eating Indian kids and fucking the English ones.
Excuse me, love. Will that make me a paedophile?
Am I racist if I won't fuck an Indian kid? Right, this has gone too far.
I'll leave it.
Excuse
then.
Me, love. With this Peshwari bread, does this make me a paedophile? It does it? Yeah, I'll just have some bread. Thank you.
Does that make me?
If you've ever asked for Peshwari bread, sort your life out. Can I have a Warburton's naan?
Have you got any other new features?
hang on. So let's give it a smooth.
Smooth.
Finn has been grafting with Harry and myself on the contents.
Right, we're going to do a few icks. And I know this is normally just relationships, but we're going to do ones where if your mate does something annoying and you think that would be horrific if you're in a relationship with them, you can include them as well. So
someone used the word masticate in the restaurant yesterday. It makes me fucking cringe.
What does that mean?
Like chew and like properly chew your food.
It's the sort of like official way of saying chewing.
Yeah.
I ate it. It just, for some reason, it's...
Shouldn't that be a blowjob then?
What?
Because if masturbate is hands, shouldn't masticate be a wank? Like a blowjob, sorry. Yeah,
a chewy?
Chew, yeah. Because I masticate there. Girl.
If you ask for a chewy in Liverpool, is that you getting noshed off?
A chew is.
Depends who you ask.
If you ask for a chewy, people will give you the chewy.
If I said to Adam, "Gives a chewy," and he shook me off,
yeah, right.
If you went up to anyone and said, "Gives a chewy," they'd be like,
"Yeah, yeah." Because I keep getting mints off sex workers, and I think I've been doing it wrong.
Yeah, chewy, lads. Please, love. That all you want?
Beef that's mints or
bubblegum flavour? That.
Yeah. So this is the ick. We need a jungle.
Cool.
Who's in charge of that?
I think I just want someone to make one for us. I think it needs more.
Ick.
You're licking me out, pack it in.
What, in?
Do, do, do.
It's 10 o'clock noon.
That's
like
the
theme tune.
This first one is from...
Doing a theme tune. Doing a theme tune.
Kate Louise. My fella eats a cheese string without peeling it. He just chomps it like a sausage. Horrible ick.
I think cheese strings are horrible.
Is it not a bit more icky for a grown man to like be like taking strings off and be like, ooh, bit by bit?
This is one of them things that women do. Half of them will say this, and then half of them will say that. And men are supposed to just go about the world and know what everyone's after.
I think I can see the fault with this feature.
How long did that take? 15
it's gonna be,
seconds?
It's going to be, why women make Adam angry. Fucking cheese. Put that on my list. Bitches and cheese. Which, by the way, is a great song waiting to happen.
10 seconds.
I got this my bitches women. And my cheese.
I think cheese.
It's not a euphemism. I mean cheese.
Cheese strings, I think they're just horrible. Baby bells. Pepper armies, have some real food. Grow up.
I like lived on pepper army and baby bells in uni. That was all I ate.
Keep it light, Carl. Keep it light.
next one. This is from
dickheads.
This is from Daniel. People who, when a dog runs towards them, let me read that again. People who, when a dog runs towards them, when they enter a room or something, and say, oh, they must be able to smell my dog on me.
Oh, my God.
No, they're just dogs, and dogs run to people. Grow up.
Fucking hell. I must be able to smell my dog. Maybe. Why are you telling me? I'm not asked. I'm not asking him what he's sniffing you for.
Can I add a dog, Ick? If when a dog runs at you, you flinch because you're scared of dogs. It makes me go,
you just boot them, don't you?
No.
I physically assault dogs.
No. That is because I don't own one. Why am I balking at that and I've just done the whole, I have a Peshwari and fuck a kid. And everyone's like, that's great time. You hate dogs, don't you? No.
You silly Billy.
I think it's because when there's a layer of truth to it, it's always more painful.
No, I love dogs.
But that is such a good one. Oh, yeah. You must be able to smell my dogs. No, he doesn't give a fuck. He's just sniffing you because he's a dog. Shut up.
But they're right though, aren't they? They count
on dogs smell everyone.
No, they don't.
Yes, they do.
They don't. Literally, Perry has been smelling me all day because I had these jeans on yesterday and Simba's all over them. Perry never does that to me.
Dogs see the world through their mouth and their nose. As in,
can
like,
I just say then, Simba's proper not arsed. Yeah. Simba just had a wander around and you're like, you're right, Simba? And he's like, whatever.
Oh, you must be smelling my dog. Bollocks. I get that a lot.
No, Wallace is not a... Wallace comes and says hello when he wants to.
Oh, he's his own boy, yeah.
He's not he's fucking people. He's like, all right, mate. Like, it's a different vibe off Wallace.
At home, I guess at 8 o'clock, he's like, right, we all chill together now. Let's cuddle.
Oh, apart from yesterday when I went in a different direction and he was like...
Oh my God, he was gutted.
That was so cute.
Yeah, he's like, where you go?
I looked back and he was like, fucking down.
Yeah, for ages, I had to drag him to the car.
I love it.
Yeah. That was mad then.
Next one from Emma. Wag, wag. My boyfriend swills all his drinks around his mouth before swallowing like it's Listerine. It's absolutely vile.
Like it's Listerine? You mean like it's wine? Like it's Listerine? I just swill it round and then I swallow it. Mouth and yeah. Throat wash.
Yeah, Listerine's for swilling it.
Oh, you're not swallowing
it. You don't swallow it though.
Oh, it's true, yeah.
Yeah.
You're meant to do that with wine, but anyone who's doing that with like Diet Coke, like, yeah.
Weird,
yeah, spit it out. That was lovely.
Yeah, if you're doing that with full sugar Dr. Pepper, you're going to lose some tags, aren't you?
Yeah, paedophile.
Okay, this one's from Double Jeffrey. People who wear skinny fit trousers that stop 2 inches above the ankle. If your trousers stop before your shoes start, you're a nonce. Fact.
Are they long shorts or short longs?
I mean, 2 inches is a lot, but your trousers are supposed to stop before your shoes. Yeah, I just have trousers that are 2 inches longer than all my shoes. That's what I do, mate.
They don't look like shorts. They just, I can't.
No, they're just trousers that, imagine you'd roll them up. And they're just that long.
But I've seen Dean Coughlin make that look dead cool because he's got the skater vibe. He rolls his up so they're a bit higher.
I think you could pull the skates look off, you know. Yeah. Mm-hmm. If you dress like Dean, I could see that work.
You do not mean that.
Dan, right now, you're dressed like you work in a skate shop. Without a doubt. No. No, now you look like an imam.
Now you don't look like you work there. Now you look like you're banned from the skate shop.
Dan, honestly, with like the hoodie, the glasses and the hat, you look like you work in a skate shop. Oh, I'm telling you.
Do I?
Yeah.
Well.
Yeah. Well, I've never rolled my jeans up and fucking got like bare sock out.
People who don't wear socks to weddings.
With
loafers.
Loafers.
Yeah. Shoot them all in the face.
I feel like that is the epitome of the four lads that absolutely got roasted on the night out.
Yeah, yeah.
I think they might have single-handedly ended that look.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
They haven't though. If you go out in a city centre on a Saturday night and you look for it, there's still a lot of little juice heads who look like them, mate.
No one likes socks anymore.
They look like they're at judges' houses on the X Factor.
Well, speaking of, this next one's from Jess. My boyfriend wears bed socks, enough said.
Wow. Ooh. Specific bed socks. Yeah, you can't. I don't wear socks in bed. It wouldn't ick me if a girl did though. If a girl wore socks in bed, but if she was like, I'm putting my bed socks on, if she had specific bed socks.
Oh, no. What about the little, like, what's it called? The really soft, it's like teddy material, dead soft and fluffy.
Yeah, yeah. Fleece.
And they have them on.
I think it's quite sexy, man. Yeah.
Yeah.
Socks are sexy on a girl.
Socks. Oh, yeah.
No, like the thick ones that go up the shin a bit.
But if I've got socks on in bed, I'll take them out throughout the night. I'll get too hot.
It'd be so disappointing if you got back with a really hot lady and she took all the clothes off and she had like Slazenger sports socks on. That would give me
West Ham away.
So any Slazenger on anyone ever, ick.
Even a tennis player?
No, not having it.
Anna Kournikova, Slazenger on these.
I say that. I used to like the Slazenger V600. Cricket bat when I was a kid.
Oh, yeah, cricket bat, classic.
I don't know if they're still making it.
If you brought a bear back and she said, we're going to put me a cricket bat, that'd be a nick as well.
It is a Slazenger V600.
Sorry, can you hang me cricket bat up, please?
I have never met a girl who's into cricket.
I had a kookaburra and a woodworm.
You had a kookaburra?
And a woodworm, yeah.
What's a woodworm? I was a Gray Nichols man all the way. Loved it.
Big Tory,
I had a super scoop. No!
It is.
Brian Lara had the fucking Gray Nichols super scoop. Which was completely counterproductive because they took the meat out of the bat.
I like the cocoa butter or the woodworm.
I don't know what you're talking about. It sounds like animals.
But if a girl whipped out a Gray Nichols just before bed.
I don't know what a Gray Nichols is, Dan.
It's a cricket bat.
It's a bumhole.
In context of the conversation, you could have guessed.
But he's saying cocoa butters, and that sounds like a little like a marsupial.
A cocoa butter is a small Australian bird, yeah?
Right. It's an Australian cricket bat company.
Right.
And woodworm as well.
Right. Okay. Cool.
Classic bats.
Gun and more. Yeah, he doesn't give a fuck.
Couple more. This one's from Charlie. My bird likes sucking my tongue when we neck. It makes me want to gag, but I've not said anything yet.
That's class.
I like that.
Suck or bite anything on me.
You have to be going for it, though. If you go for the peck and you suck your tongue, it's like, whoa,
whoa. Eyelid. No. Suck.
No.
Wow.
No. No. Don't suck my eyelids. No. Or I your hair. My eyelids sucked all
your hair.
What?
Don't suck your hair either.
Your hair as well. Yeah, when I said anything. Do you know what? No, I just realised there, boys. There is limitations to that, yeah? Yeah. Don't suck my hair. Don't suck my eyelids. That might be the only two things, though.
Your ass cheeks.
Tongue up the nostril.
Bite my ass cheeks. Yeah.
Suck your ass cheeks.
Yeah, sound.
Like they're trying to get a fucking thick milkshake.
Suck my ass if you want. Yeah.
Tongue in the nostril.
If you want.
No.
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 Or, not up my nostrils.
Licking the side of your mouth.
What, have I left some sauce there?
No, like...
Left some sauce?
If she just exclusively just licked the joint between your lower lip and your upper lip.
I think that would probably do it for me. Mm. Damn, what would you do if someone put a straw up your ass? That is so good.
I'd just watch them die, probably. I can't see that that's going to be well.
You're forgetting he's got a poisonous arsehole.
No, poo's poisonous.
Mistake made.
Poo's poisonous.
I think poo's poisonous.
If you eat loads of it, yeah, but if someone's just sucking your arsehole. Oh, yeah,
but also shouldn't just be shite waiting to be sucked out your arsehole at any moment.
Oh, sorry, where do I keep it? In my fucking...
In your bowels.
In your bowels?
In my bowels.
What are you talking about?
In my bowels. They're connected to my fucking lower bowel. There's my arsehole.
Arsehole hasn't just got shite in it right now.
In your ass. In your bumhole, man.
You should be able to put your finger up your ass and come out pooless.
I couldn't do that with confidence.
I could.
Yeah, we've got the toilet seat of the dream.
I don't think you could. I know your medical anal history.
Yeah, not and well. I'm saying even I could.
Well, should we have a break and find out? Who's going to press fucking record? Right, I don't know. It's not going to be good.
We've got one more. This is from Jonathan. One of my mates called his pajamas gym jams the other day and it knocked me sick. Get to prison, you massive sex offender.
Yeah, birds would leave you for that.
Yeah, that's...
Just going to get me gym chems on.
Do you want
you line up the good wife.
Sorry, Kate, if I'm lower than her, looking up.
Yeah, you've told me that before.
Yeah. So like, say we're on the couch and you're the big spoon. Like, she's there, you're watching the telly. If we switch, she's like, looking up at me makes me sick. Like,
so can you never lie on a comfortable bosom and have your hair stroked?
No, I'll usually lie more on her belly.
So even lower?
Yeah, but I'm not doing that, am I? Like an owl. But like, oh, I love you.
So if she was ever on a pavement and you were like on the lower bit and you went for a hug, she'd be like, oh.
Not that. No, because I'm taller than her. Probably got the same height there.
That's a power thing, isn't it? That's how they show power in films. Is like if you film from above, they're the powerful one. And if you're looking up, they're the ones that are like, the bad guy would be
there. She doesn't want to be like, oh, I'm a little boy. She feel like I'm a... She also said that's the reason she'd never peg me. Not that I've asked her to. She said... It wouldn't
just came up apropos of nothing.
It wouldn't be the pegging, it'd be when I turned back and looked at her. Like she would have to leave me.
Just don't do that then.
What would you do?
Just like, get bummed like, and face
she's
forward.
She's fucking belting.
Yeah.
Just get bummed and face forward.
This. Like a real man.
Yeah. I don't know if you need to make eye contact when you're being bummed by your missus. Do you?
No.
You don't have to.
I don't think you want to, do you?
Well, I don't want to get bummed at all, actually.
Oh, I'd love to try a peg.
I know you would.
But would you look? Would you look back at this?
Ooh. God, watch me skirt. No, I don't know. I don't think you need the eye contact. Just bury your fucking head in a pillow with shame in your dirty heart.
And ass. No, she likes to be me to be the man.
She does, doesn't she?
Mm. Yeah, that's what she likes. Which might be, you know, might be a bit. Heteronormative.
I was on the on our house, like the doorstep, and Laura was just down the step, and I gave her a hug, and I was another like 4 inches taller. I'm 3 inches taller than Laura, and I went, "Oh my god, you feel tiny. Would you like it if I was tall?" And she instantly went, "Oh yeah, great."
Yeah,
because you're generalizing.
Yeah,
most women like a tall dude, don't they?
Heteronormative thing to be like, wrap me up. Put me in your pocket.
That's why I feel so lucky that I'm 6'3".
You are, aren't you?
Take me to being
6'3". Making up numbers.
Send your icks to haveawordpod@gmail.com. We'll be getting through them over the next few weeks.
Right, we've got a question from Aiden. He says, Lids, the Olympic torch has just been lit. Where's the Olympic? Is that Paris?
Paris?
Paris.
Why? Did they not get London and now... I feel like... Did Paris not get the London Olympics in 2012?
They definitely didn't get that one.
But weren't they in the...
Yeah.
They were like the other finalists.
Yeah. They'll have had it loads, though, surely.
Have Paris never had the Olympics before?
No, they've surely had it a couple of times.
So the torch has just been lit, which means it goes from wherever the last one, the last Olympics was, to the new one. Is that what they do?
Is it, yeah. The last one was in Japan. It's going to be hard, though.
The last time they did it was in 100 years ago. 1924 right, was the last time Paris right. did it.
Could we have a football tournament in this country, please?
We have.
Fucking. What?
The Euros?
Last year? Or 2 years ago?
What?
You had the Euros in England 2 years ago.
Did we?
Yeah. There was quite a bit of trouble at Wembley.
Oh. Was it split with someone else? Was it just the English? Who was it?
England got to the final.
It
was all of Europe. That's cheating. I want a fucking proper tournament.
Okay. The final was in Wembley, though, in the semi-finals.
Yeah, but the whole tournament was all over Europe.
I don't think we're going to get one after what happened at Wembley either.
We're hosting the 2028, England and UK and Ireland. We're hosting 2028 Euros.
Is that what they're doing now? They're just doing them all over the place?
Yeah.
Oh, it's well better when it's just one country.
Yeah.
How bad was it, Wembley? I genuinely can't remember.
England played Italy and London was on fire, essentially.
Because England fans are...
There's a documentary that came out, was it like 3 days ago?
Yeah. England fans are just awful people, aren't they?
Right. Yeah. But Paris aren't fucking... No, like...
Yeah, Paris will be chaos as well.
Yeah, because their police are wild.
But maybe
and
they
also, Paris is like the new terrorism hotspot, innit? Like, I was genuinely worried about going to do the Paris Marathon because I thought I might get fucking ISIS.
Paris is a huge...
Sally Donald.
Yeah, I don't know why. I think it's the... I can't remember what it is now. It's their stance on something, isn't it? I can't remember what it is, but Paris is a huge hotspot for terrorists.
Right, well, they're getting the fucking Olympics. The torch has been lit. If the IOC came to their senses and brought the Olympics to Liverpool, what would the opening ceremony look like and how would you scouse up the events? Where would they be held?
Pogues. Everyone's got OG 110s on. Everyone.
Oh, yeah. The opening ceremony's in Pogues. Everyone's just on the Guinness having some sort of...
Which scouse celebrities would be in? Because do you remember the 2012, they had the James Bond sketch with the Queen?
Pete Price.
If you're making it like scouse Twitter funny, then yeah, Pete Price is there. And there's all just like name, like faceless accounts, but people just know they're like avatars from Twitter.
Who was the guy?
Scouse Mar, big cartoon blonde woman, big tits.
If they actually did it, Paul McCartney would be that he'd be the fucking... If the IOC were like, they would absolutely.
Perhaps. Yeah. Paul Smith, speaking of Paul McCartney in the pool now, mate. More people have seen Paul Smith in the last 5 years than Paul McCartney.
That's only because Paul McCartney hasn't done any shows, though, isn't it?
Probably, yeah. That's not Paul Smith's fault.
If Paul McCartney started playing Hot Water more, I think his clips would do bits.
Ray Quinn.
What?
Ray Quinn's involved.
What was he doing?
Playing the piano or something.
For Paul McCartney or Skazma.
He'd be there playing maybe like a villain in the panto at half time.
He'd still put a panto on. He won't do anything unless it's a panto.
If you're going to scouse it up, like scouse Forgotten Stars love being in panto. Rebecca Ferguson.
Yeah.
Like Les Dennis.
Ray Quinn.
Marcus Collins. He cuts hair as well.
Yeah. You could do everyone's hair. The Olympics. Olympic Village would be like Kenny. Everyone's bags would go missing and shit. It'd be fucking sick. Old Swan Tesco would be like, fuck, I'm not everyone sleeps in the army. Getting a Olympic will be well better.
Where's the 100 metres held? I know that's just that's always in a stadium though. But they do some mad shit Ratty outside,
Park.
Don't they?
Ratty Park.
What do they do outside?
Marathon.
Marathon, yeah.
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 The marathon's outside, but they actually have like some of the sports are... Like, there's in-stadium sports.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
All the athletics
and there's
in
like
stadium.
BMXing and stuff. That's somewhere else.
That's Ratty Park.
Ratty Park.
And all the swimming.
Swimming at being out in Leisure Centre.
We all eat waves.
No, just in the Mersey.
We build eat waves. Wave. That'd be class, actually. 100 metres fucking...
Waves in the big pool.
They'd put waves in the big pool. That'd be class.
Yeah. Unbelievable. Salt and pepper chicken off. Good player.
Some Russian weightlifter.
I don't think he's allowed. He's Russian. He's going to have to be an independent. He's jacked salt and pepper chicken off.
I like the war hunt one, me. When they're all running, but like their ass. Why? So they're not allowed to like run. But,
yeah. Doesn't it have to be your foot? Like
one foot's going to be on the ground at all times.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So they all walk like someone who needs a shite in Morrison's.
Can I just say, I'm fucking great at that walking. I haven't got enough
you
space.
You have. Do it right there. You've got a moving camera.
I haven't got enough space.
What? Start doing it.
What are you talking about? Do it from how big do you think your legs get when you do this
wall? Do it from that wall.
Hang on. Wow.
I've seen you do that before as well when you're running off with bevies.
You're not that good at it.
It should be impossible to pull a hamstring unless you're sprinting.
It's very camp.
Also,
you. Oh, sorry. I'll do the manly version of walking.
You look like Peter Man.
The campest fucking Olympic event in history.
Dressage.
Yeah, it'd be good that. See you in Liverpool, 2032.
Yeah.
Yeah. Why not?
I've hurt my leg.
How?
I don't know. I just.
You're fucked in India. You mean
tense it?
Have you been working out still?
A little bit, yeah. I've been shadow boxing in saunas. From before.
You're not just doing lap pull down, are you?
Yeah.
Why?
I just because I love lap pull downs. I'm like, yes!
You don't need your shoulders.
I do. I want to be able to pull myself up off a ledge if I'm hanging off it.
Who's he?
Nice.
You know, you need to strengthen your legs, don't you?
Maybe. I do a little bit of leg. Nice. I just don't do camp walking. It was just a bit of a shock. I would smoke. I'd smoke anyone at the fast walking.
What are you benching?
Do you reckon you've got it?
You'd smoke anyone at the fast walking. You've just done 8 yards of it and pulled your hamstring.
Yeah, but if I just warm my hamstring up a bit.
What are you benching?
What?
Were you lifting? You deadlifting?
No.
Are you literally just in the gym?
I don't deadlift. I don't.
Are you literally just doing lap pull down and going on?
I go in, do lap pull downs, have a sauna, watch someone shadow box, and it's great. I'm just going to be dead good at pulling myself up a bit.
Can you do a pull up?
No, not yet. What do you mean?
So the only thing you're training you can't do?
Because it's hard, isn't it? I weigh loads.
Do all the things.
I've got to build up to it. I'm getting there with the lap pull down.
You've been going to the gym for like 6 weeks and you're still doing one exercise every time you go and then going for sit down?
I'm being stupid. I do a few.
What else should
things.
I do? Do leg pressing?
I don't want to fuck off, Carl. What do you do?
The things that I'm telling you. Right. I'm a PT who tells me what to do.
I don't do the benchy one. I do the loose one. I don't want to get stuck under it.
Do you go in the squat racks?
What was this then? Are you training to be a cheerleader? What's that?
I do the pushing away from me, but I do it with two loose dumbbells. And get a rhythm going.
You do that's benching with dumbbells, yeah.
Yeah.
You need a PT who tells you what to do.
I know. Because I just go and please myself.
Yeah. You're not meant to be happy in the gym.
Well,
I think you just go to the gym for a break, don't you?
It's nice. Then I listen to podcasts. Look at Bundas, listen to podcasts. It's a dream.
We'll go to the gym together.
That'd be nice.
I'm going for my first run in ages tonight.
Back on the running?
Gonna have to.
I think you should walk like me. Right, let's call it. Been a belter. Appreciate your lids.
We've got some music.
Yeah.
What a bag of quality. What?
Tour first?
Two tour dates left. Yeah. Coventry and Liverpool. That's it. Come and see me. Adam Rodico at UK.
And the arena.
That's Liverpool.
Oh, yeah. You're not doing another tour date with all of it.
Two left, yes. Come on.
Four at the time of recording, but two by the time it goes out.
Just before we get to this week's song, I've got a new song coming out on the 10th of
Wonderful.
May.
What's it called?
It's called Dead Time. If you go to any of the links in my bios on any
time,
social media.
You dropped some new music, you know. I've been fucking itching. I can't stop playing your other stuff.
Yeah. It's called Dead Time and you'll hear it in a few weeks.
Brought this on yourself, Finn.
I did, yeah. Just go and pre-save it.
Wow!
It does me a massive favour.
It will be good. He's good.
You've heard it.
I've pre-saved
I have actually heard it. I said this last time. It is a good song.
I downloaded Amazon Music just so I could pre-save it twice in case one of the apps fucks up on the day.
Thank you. Deadlift, though?
Deadlift? I can't.
It's called Don't Dead Time.
So this week's song is called Fool's Game and it's by a young Scouse band called In The Ranks.
Wonderful.
Go and check them out.
Great.
Spotify, Amazon, wherever.
That's fantastic.
That's fantastic.